the advantage on his.
This afternoon, Essendon have lost their last two.
We got a party going on and it's a free for all. I can't quite hear you, the music's so loud. Just drive this way until you see the crowd. The cars will be parked all up in the yard. The doorbell's buzzing, so knock real hard. No, on second thought.
Hi there, everybody. Welcome along to Subiaco Oval for one of the great rivalries in the AFL. It's the West Coast Eagles and Essendon. Both these sides needing a win this afternoon. Essendon have lost their last two games and the West Coast Eagles have lost two of their last three. Overcast afternoon, strong westerly breeze going down the ground. There's Michael Malthouse and it is a sellout. I'm joined now by Ross Glendinning. And Ross, both sides looking better for what could be virtually a final in terms of their season.
Yes, and I think so, and it's led that way with the build-up, and I think there's been some ducks and drakes so far. If you look at the West Coast lineup, out of their side is Heady and Hart. So coming in are Trent Cummings for his first run, and Brendan Fuster, who I think will be a welcome return, Dennis. I think you're a fan of his, and I think through centre-half forward or in a key forward spot, he'll be very, very handy.
What about the Bombers?
Well, they've made a lot of changes here. Simons and also Moorcroft out of their side, and Fraser and Blumfield come in. But I think the additions of Alessio, particularly Somerville in the midfield and the ruck to combat Ilya Grigic, will make it a very, very tight contest.
Set to go then. It's the Eagles and the Bombers back with all of the action right after this.
If the house is rocking.
Okay, now let's have a look here.
Oh, that's not a good one. You put your book there, if you want.
Okay, now who are these people? Morrison. Cummings.
Josh. Got a bandage down on his right knee.
Thanks,
socks mate. Down, jumper out.
Cummings. Thanks. Fuster.
21 is Schofield. 23 is Fuster.
Having a shot from outside.
I'm going to use that one there because it's a better picture than that
okay,
one.
Okay, mate.
It's a bit blurry.
You okay with that? I'll try and sit back as best I can. There's Denham and Fraser. O'Connor, Hurd. Seaty, Somerville, Barnard, Young, McDonald, Alessio sitting on the ground, Cousins.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Yes, Adrian, can you hear me, son?
Yep.
Hello, Adrian.
G'day, Dan, got you, mate.
Okay, mate, good. Good. Blockbuster, it's a blockbuster game.
Don't use that word, Barry, we're sick of it. Not from you, but from everyone.
So hey, they moved their change rooms because of superstition. I'll have to talk about that, won't I?
Okay, now what are we doing? Are we doing the umpires or not?
I don't think we're doing anything.
Okay, so it's just down to Adrian, is it?
Actually, might even be when after the game starts.
Oh, that's all right, mate. No, but I noticed not the rundown, that's all. So we don't do that. Just down to Adrian, is it?
They've told me it's not till after the bounce, but you might have to check with Shane.
O'Donnell has won the toss. The Bombers will run on the breeze in the opening term, right to left, as we say good afternoon to Peter McKenna. Pete, who do you like here?
Good afternoon, Dennis. Well, I actually like Essendon a bit today. I think they have to win, more so than the Eagles. They've got a great record against the Eagles. I know it's difficult to win at Subi, but I believe in past records. I give the Bombers a chance.
Adrian Barrich is prowling down there on the boundary line. Adrian, what can you tell us?
Well, Dennis, it's been a remarkable start to this game. The mind games have been unbelievable. The Bombers ran out 24 players before the game. And the reason they did that is because they couldn't fit into their change room. They changed their change rooms at the last moment because of superstition. They don't believe they play well out of the other change rooms 7 and 8, so they've moved over change rooms 3 and 4. They're pokey and tiny and terrible, so they had to run all their boys out here and have a warm-up out on the ground. Just incredible scenes. The Eagles held their players over until right just before the death knock. Heady and Hart out. Fuster and Cummings coming in. This will be a blockbuster if the build-up has anything to do with it.
Adrian Barrich. Brendan Fuster. Back to the Falcons last week in the West Star Rules competition. Lining up this afternoon for the West Coast Eagles. Start of the game then at Subiaco Oval. What a big one. Both sides in a slump. Somerville won it down. Kemp. Simmons down towards half forward. Grigic. Still inside the centre square. Runners to the outside. Goes to one of them. Morrison in space. Long handball down towards Cousins. About 60 metres out from goal. Back to Morrison. Morrison surrounded, gets it away, ball right on the 50. Strong tackle got him down. Philip Matera throws it on the boot. 2-on-1 here, in from the side. Donnelly, only about 35 metres out.
Yeah, terrific start for Andrew Donnelly to get his hands on it early in a clean possession like that. And Ilya Grigic, who's such an important player with the inclusion of Somerville for Essendon, getting early touches as well, which is important.
Never likely. Dustin Fletcher. Bombers bench. Moorcroft, Young, and Morgan. Meanwhile, Fletcher boots in, members side. Grigic over the top. Big fist away, gets it out of bounds about 60 metres from the Eagles' attacking goal. As we said, it's a sellout. So much talk this week about this game. Somerville. Two-fisting it up towards the wing. Cousins. Pass Pryor. Pulls it back towards half-forward. Palmer's there in number. Joe Massidi. Very good last week against the Saints.
So this is Joe Massidi at half-back. A very important player, as is Peter Somerville, who's back in this side. Chris Danaher driving it to half-forward. He's looking for Ricky Ola Renshaw. This is Matt Lloyd. Matera is there also. Ola Renshaw unable to keep it in. It'll be a throw-in at half-forward.
Forecast. 19 degrees currently. Nice for footy. The sun peeking through. O'Connor hooks it down. Schofield got it to Cousins at half-back. Feeds it wide. Morrison has been busy. Hugging the boundary line, goes down towards half forward. Philip Matera slipping away from Doolan. Just forward of the wing. Matera across the ground, ball, one of two. Takes it, he's away. Bounces through the centre square. Probing kick across the ground, ill directed. Hardwick plays on immediately. Lucas breaking away with the left boot towards the wing. Turnbull did brilliantly, backed himself against the ball. Doolan in the opposite direction. Now O'Connor on the wing, grabbed from behind by Kemp, affected the kick. Getting it behind out there was McIntosh on his knees, got it to Kemp, well played. Overlapping, this is McKenna into Mines, goes for distance now. Down towards half forward and Lewis. He's about 75 metres from goal, Chris Lewis. Pulls it inside the 50, loose ball, Fletcher lost it. Diving on top of it, Danaher. Donnelly did well, got it across to support. Matera in the grasp. Griggich on the 50, Lewis, men on in the middle, Schofield is marked about 40 metres out directly in front.
Terrific play and good play by the players on the outer side, Lewis, Griggich, to combine and keep the ball in play and then the vision to centre the ball. And for those players, options, there were three or four, Banfield, Schofield, quite a number there to hit the ball to just inside 50. Well read.
Eagles into the breeze. It'll fall short. Fuster turns around, still he goes. Wellman's got him, good tackle too. Matera to Lewis, off his step, 20 metres out. To behind, it is.
Yes, Dennis, watching the Colts game before this, they were certainly kicking about 10 metres further to the left of screen, so Essendon would want to make the most of this breeze. Certainly can score both ends. Now, Dustin Fletcher has developed into one of the best backmen in the competition. It's at half-back to the Bombers. The Eagles go forward again. This is Simmons to half-forward. Morrison did it well. On to Donnelly. Now Kemp. Kemp into an open goal. And he has popped it through. So first blood to the Eagles.
Yes, and a bit of class there too. Kemp just realising the player coming toward him. So just a little feint to get back onto his right foot. Just watch this again. In the congestion, Banfield just using the ball well. And Simmons spotting teammate in Morrison, who knew that the inside player Donnelly could give off to Kemp. There's that little evasive step. Clever goal.
Well, it's been all West Coast so far, kicking into the breeze. Somerville against Griggich. Griggich hooked it down with the left hand. O'Donnell, it's eventually socketed off the ground to the half-forward line. Hurd, Gehrig's picking him up. James Hurd after it, a quick kick. Down into the forward area. The Bombers could well do to get a goal here. This is Barnard, former Hawk. Further afield is Alessio. Back to Barnard, just gets a little toe poke to it. O'Donnell receives the handball. It's smothered off the boot. Fraser couldn't control it. And almost a high tackle on her, but the umpire claiming that was legal. So there'll be a bounce about 25 metres out from the Essendon goal.
As you mentioned, Pete Gehrig has got hurt. Jakovic with Alessio. And McIntosh has got Lloyd.
And in charge this afternoon. Most experienced there, Dennis Rich. A particularly good bounce. Schofield, totally done. The man playing his 150th. Matera, brilliant stuff coming out of defence. Not much up the ground for him. Hardwick has marked about 75 metres out. Kicks on the breeze. You can see Barnard remonstrating down in front. Meantime, Gehrig over the top of the pack. Olerenshaw did well. O'Donnell had to wait. Now he's got problems. And the bounce about 40 metres out from the attacking goal for the Bombers. Adrian, what about that breeze?
Yeah, Dennis, very interesting about that breeze. In the Eagles' back half, it is very strong, probably 2 to 3 goals. When they get up the ground in front of the three-tier stand, not so bad, though.
It's 40 metres out from the Bombers' goal. Here's Chad Morrison giving it off to Peter Matera. As Dennis said, game number 150, and not too many poor ones in that 150, I would suggest.
Gary O'Donnell coming off, Pete, to have been replaced by Danny Morgan.
Eagles bench. See Tony Evans sitting there, punched away by Griggetts. That was Morrison, taken by Morgan, who's just come on the ground. Morrison again. It's Cousins getting it further afield. It's Guy McKenna to the centre wing area. Good pass and a good mark to Donnelly. Now, ball's running for him. He's running back with the flight. Lucas has got him. Oh, he did that well, Jason Ball. No, he doesn't attempt to get it out, really. And the umpire's giving him a bit of leeway. It'll be a bounce.
The other players appreciated a bit more of a free rein so far today is Ben Cousins. Set a bit of it early.
Bounce right half forward for the Eagles. It floats towards the boundary line. Ball inside the 50. Massidi over it. Across the line. Smokinger, number 24. Generally sees a lot of the ball. Thrown in, Fletcher, Rook Fuster under the ball, Pryor, a beneficiary of that. Danaher, telling kick across the ground, Fraser, always his, plays on immediately, alongside the centre circle, good hustle back there from Kemp, affected the kick, Lloyd, terrific grab. Point of the square, out towards left half forward, chips it inside the 50, Olerenshaw needs to go, spoiled by Barnard, a late arrival, spills across to Hurd. Simmons in space, well worked. McKenna, Banfield over his head though, storming through Hardwick, well shepherded by Morgan, centers the ball. Olerenshaw went back with courage. Lloyd off the deck, in goes Hurd, as he's taken high, held to him, and the bounce right on the 50.
So the Eagles certainly will be watching James Hurd very carefully, a very important player to Essendon. As we said earlier, Fraser Geary is on him, and Gehrig, a very, very quick player. Look at him facing him front on at the moment, even at this bounce. It's knocked down by O'Connor, just outside 50. That's Denham. Schofield went without it. Morrison. Morgan also. Cousins did well to get it to Peter Matera. Here's Schofield again. Looks very much like Guy McKenna in his movements. Schofield to half forward, to Jason Ball. He tunnel balls it. Fletcher goes back. He's got support from Doolan. And then eventually it's forced over the line.
Ball out of bounds, left half forward. What about Kevin Shitty's thoughts on his team this afternoon?
I definitely got a very good reception, I can assure you, after I got up and beat us in the last couple of minutes of the day. So, look, I rest assured, I know what's coming when I get off the plane over in West Australia.
Some thoughts on his last visit here. Doesn't mind it, here's Schofield. Inside the centre square, puts it inside the 50. Dug out well by Hardwick and Massidi. Wellman kicks towards right centre wing. In front of O'Connor, left it behind. Lewis gathers the ball in space now. Chris Lewis. O'Connor's done brilliantly. Charged the hand pass down, applying great pressure, but weight of numbers tell the story eventually. Turnbull puts it back towards half forward. And the mark is held by Danaher, going back with a flight of it. Feeds it to Fletcher. Fletcher towards midfield. Plenty of Eagles. Griggetts gathered the bouncing ball off to Kemp. Kemp floats it towards half forward. Banfield's in front, knocked away by Hardwick. A battle after it again. It was well worked by the Bombers. Coming through, this is Danaher. Morgan got it to him. The kick down towards half forward. Helped on its way by Barnard inside the 50. Alessio, still Alessio, across to Hurd. Hurt off a step. That's a magnificent effort. I think it's a goal. Oh, what a great kick.
Yeah, no question, Dennis. That's outstanding play. And the plaudits coming back to Danner and also teammates across halfback were able to get that ball forward. And Barnard did the right thing in the end. Perhaps could have tried to mark, but punched it on. And then the agility and speed of Alessio playing in front. You would have thought from just outside 50, that distance would have been too far for Hurd, but off one step, beautiful timing and accuracy.
Well, you can always count on James Hurd that when a goal is badly needed to do something, Grigich goes to ground, Schofield goes in against Morgan, and the umpire will bounce it again.
It's just the area there where Jakovic just has to be a bit careful. If Alessio's in front, he does have deceptive pace. He can't sit too far behind him.
You're right, Rossi's a very mobile guy for a fellow who's about 6 foot six. And again, Somerville. Well, he used his body very well. Off the ground by Masiti. Now Somerville to the half forward line for the Bombers. Socket away by McIntosh. Taken by Ryan O'Connor. A hurry kick to the forward line. McKenna will try and trap it. Gives it off very quickly to Matera. A bit of talent amongst those two. Simmons at halfback, close to the boundary line. He might try and take it over. No, keeps it in pretty cleverly in the finish. Able to give it back to Guy McKenna on the Matera. Matera, a low trajectory kick. He was looking for Donnelly, but chipping in was Joe Masiti.
On the wing, back inside the 50. Third the target. Gehrig, got a fist on it. Bounds it goes inside the attacking 50 for the Bombers. Paul Barnard back in the team. And a sea of faces at Subi. Great atmosphere, this one. And the build-up during the week to match it. Turnbull, powerfully. Out of bounds again. Under 10 minutes to quarter time. Hurd, clean possession, tackled immediately, and the bounce. That's a better one. Turnbull with the left hand, Masiti over the top, knocks it away from Schofield, who's been busy.
See, there's talk, Dennis, in the paper this morning that the rules committee believing that they might reconsider the last player to touch the ball. Rule going out of bounds to kick the opposition, which I think is ludicrous.
Got that off your chest. Masiti to Hurd. Therapeutic, was it?
That's
inside the 50. Barnard over the top. It's out of bounds.
But just because this is set up here with Ryan Turnbull in the first instance just punching the ball back over the line. And now we've had three or four sessions here. I just can't see that working.
Not on the Talking Footy Monday nights. I was going to say, not on that last one either. He knocked it out of bounds. I suppose we would have had a throw in. Meantime, McIntosh got it from Lewis. Forward of half back, a little 1-2, and now a third. Jakovic. Out against the line, Glenn Jakovic cuts a couple of paces infield and boots down towards half forward, but in front, Fletcher. Dustin Fletcher. So good, so reliable back there. Crossed the ground, fixed him. Straight to Grigich.
Oh, that was a terrible kick, wasn't it?
It's uncanny the way that works, isn't it?
You should be in the coach's box.
Out there on the ground just talking to the opposition. The designated talker.
Yes, I mean, he is a very good kick normally, but that's the risk you take if you come across the ground. Kicks have to be spot on. That was nowhere near it. Barnard is off. Blomfield on, being picked up by McKenna.
Grigich from just outside the 50. Important kick. Will it carry? Not quite. Strong hands down there from Ball. No mark though. Lucas chips it out towards half back. Simmons hasn't got it surely. He'll get the free. It's about 55 metres out from goal.
Poor play by Pryor actually. Ross,
yeah,
wasn't
untidy for an experienced player, yes.
Simmons wants to go in short. Awkward one for Ball. Very low and very hard at about face height, as it turned out. He was sliding and couldn't control it.
2 points the margin. West Coast in front. They've done fairly well because certainly the breeze is favouring left of screen. Ball trying to take it out of that ruck contest. Here's danger for the Bombers because Philip Matera grabbed it and then eventually it came off hands and over the line, about 15 metres around from the Eagles' goal. Not a lot of scoring so far. It's pretty tight and tough out there. So Jason Ball to do the ruck work against Peter Somerville. Somerville, now he punched that 20 metres straight back to the line, and I think his every intention, Roscoe, was to put it back over.
Exactly.
And wearing the number made famous by his dad, the late John Somerville. When I was a kid and barracking for Essendon, Roscoe, one of my heroes he was. Now that's good play by Cousins to Donnelly and bumped hard by Fletcher as he was going to kick a certain goal. Good play by Fletcher to put the pressure on. 1-3 the Eagles, Essendon one straight goal.
Yeah, good play by both players there. Initially to keep the ball in play by Cousins, then Donnelly, wasn't much he can do about this. That split second to get the ball to boot, either a tackle or a hip and shoulder by Fletcher would have been effective.
So Fletcher better kick in that time to Denham. This is Ben Doolan. An ordinary hand pass to Chris Danaher, and the Eagles come in. Handball straight to Devon from Griggett, taken by Mark Fraser. In towards Hurd. Hurd and Gehrig, that'll be a fantastic contest. Turnbull went without it. Good play by Ricky Ollerenshaw. Gets it to Pryor. That's cleverly done by Pryor. Great sidestepping, and he goes for home. That is a brilliant goal.
I agree with you, Pete. That's as good as you can get some days in football because of the traffic that was in front of him to gather the ball in the first instance. When they were in a bit of trouble off half back, they got out of it. Turnbull did pretty well to get through the pack and push the ball forward, but then the handball fed out, base of skills, and then to actually kick the goal after that was just outstanding. Well done, Michael Pryor, after that early indiscretion on the half back line against Paul Simmons.
It's low scoring, and the Bombers lead it by 3 points. Rucks go at it again. Grigic twisted away by Masidi. Gathered on the half volley by Simmons. Nice hand pass, sending Lewis into space. He kicks inside the 50. Fletcher leading in the race to the ball. Gathers to Lucas. Goes wider still. Doolan, all close to the line. Fraser with no support. Looked inside, then decided, nope, I'll take her away. So boundary throw in. Chris Lewis having a fine season. They need him this afternoon. Lucas and Ball, only as far as Morgan. Danaher on the burst, up from the back pocket, runs towards midfield, probing kick, intended for Hurd, overcommitted Gehrig as a result. Hurd quickly around, magnificent finish. Alessio dropped the mark, coming through Matera, knocked it away from Ollerenshaw, and now can run it out. Ollerenshaw back behind him, and he's Wake on his knees. He kicks it up towards half forward. Down goes Ball. Lucas was held without it. Heads for the boundary line. Morgan gains about 15 metres, and it will be thrown in.
So it's a disappointing drop mark by Alessio. When you have all that play set up for you, then you're on the lead. You're playing a position like that where you get in front. If you don't take them, such a waste.
And Jason Ball, was it? Jason, yep. Ball limping around there. He looks very much like a Fuster. Now, Grigic. Essendon looked very switched on in this game. Chad Morrison did well. Good effort by the young fella. Cousins bending it back into the half forward area. Some good strong play by Wellman. Pryor. I reckon they look pretty well switched on, this Essendon side today, as Hardwick goes out to centre wing. This is Denham. He brings it back to half forward. And Blumfield, is it? At the bottom of that pack, I think it's Justin Blumfield, it is. And he was caught, but had no chance of getting rid of it.
Jason Ball coming off the ground, it seems. He's been busy so far, too. Providing a target. O'Connor wrestled down. Pryor having a good term. Close to the boundary line. It's across now, despite the best intentions of Blumfield. Ball staying out there. This is where it happened, I think. They're getting squeezed under the body there, and the weight of the man coming from behind didn't help. Morgan gains about 10 metres. Morrison, Lewis wasn't tall enough. on the bounce. What was your view on Jason Ball, Adrian?
Dennis, Jason Ball will be coming off to have his ankle re-strapped. He's rolled his ankle and will need a bit of treatment. I think he'll go back on.
Turnbull, big fist. Massidi hasn't got it. Still a battle after it. O'Connor off the ground by Lewis. Hardwick in the opposite direction. Gains about 25 metres and it bounces out of bounds. You can see the 50 in the distance there. The attacking 50 for Essendon.
It's umpire Dennis Rich here, who's actually, he was over the boundary line when that tackle came to Massidi. He definitely didn't have the ball. Why that wasn't a free kick.
The Bombers by 3 points. Turnbull against Ryan O'Connor. Lewis is looking quite dangerous here. Lovely hand pass to Guy McKenna to Banfield. Banfield is on centre wing. Swings onto his left. And a low trajectory drop punt. Oh, but when that ball was further than 5 metres away, I would have thought. Good play by Cousins, down towards half forward, and he's a hobbling Jason Ball. Limps after the umpire's called play on, and that was pretty ordinary football in the finish, but I'm sure Jason Ball is worried about the leg and wanted to give the pass off Roscoe.
Well, if he's no good, he's got to come off. If you're going to be half-paced like that, particularly for a big fellow who doesn't have the greatest mobility, you've got to come off the ground. Terrific work by Cousins, though, gee, that's skillful stuff. He's been under a lot of pressure in the last couple of weeks, so... I said earlier, he's had 3 and 4 so far, so a bit of the footy.
They've been manning him up in recent weeks, and some people have been saying unfairly. Here's Chad Morrison. Oh, good smothering by Wellman. That was excellent play. Chris Danaher came through. Hardwick, he went without it. Here's little Denham. He's a tough little nut. Brings it to the centre of the ground because he saw Mark Fraser, who can run, and drives it to half forward. Should be a mark. Oh, he's got terrific hands, Matthew Lloyd. Onto the left, brings it down to Alessio. Yes, he's got it this time. Beautiful kick by Lloyd, and a good lead by the big fella at full forward.
But that's the one that he, the previous effort, Pete, when the ball came toward him, he should have taken this one. Perhaps a little more difficult too, just a bit higher. Still the spoiling arm of Jakic to hit the arm of Alessio, not strong enough to break the marking attempt.
So with Peter Somerville back in this side, it allows them the luxury of having Alessio up in one of those key forward positions. So Stephen Alessio from directly in front has put it through the middle for goal. So the Bombers looking quite good here and quite dangerous. 3 goals straight, plays 1-4.
Yes, as Ball comes off and coming on to replace him is Josh Wood. And we see this again. Well, Alessio was the player in the elimination final last year with 5 goals in the forward area. And... Jakic, of course, wasn't able to play in that game with his knee, but it's the dangerous player that he can be in that situation.
Approaching quarter time, must say too, the Bombers are running on a pretty strong breeze. I'm not sure they'd be happy with this first term. They look good deep inside their 50, but they need some late goals here. Just over 2 minutes to go. Fraser inside the 50 with that kick. Matera towards the boundary line. Helps it across. Is it off the boot? The question hangs in the air, but it will be a boundary throw-in. Here's on Gary O'Donnell. He seems to be okay. Just off for team balance, as they say, which is interesting. O'Donnell has a great record against the West Coast Eagles. Averages 24 possessions over the last 5 games. Gehrig towards the boundary line. Seedy and Morrison watch it across. Kevin Sheedy is down on the boundary. Distance is Gary O'Donnell. Two minutes to quarter time. Somerville, Rigich, Hurd, a half chance. Schofield through his legs. Lewis left it behind. Hurd somehow found it. Wellman upended. Oh, it's like a pinball machine in there at the moment. Bouncing around. Kemp, brilliantly done. Kept it in. Gave it to McIntosh. Working in a phone booth, and they got the ball and controlled it. Here's Donnelly. Donnelly, the defensive side of left centre wing.
Crowd telling him to hurry up.
Well, he couldn't see Morris in the middle, but he was blocked by the umpire and the Essendon runner.
Well, he's got him now, almost at centre half four, and Morris is looking to give it off here. The Grigich is running to the pocket. Good play by the big fella, and he's marked it. So that was excellent football by Ilya Grigich, who ran right down from the wing and has marked it about 30 metres out.
He's been effective in doing that too, Pete. He's been able to run his opposing ruckman around. His athleticism's improved. I think his fitness level's very good for a big fellow. And Somerville, who's just languishing about 30 metres behind, is now actually up inside 50, but miles too late, of course, to check his opponent.
So Ilya Grigic is normally pretty good from this range, but there's a bit of breeze out there. It won't be so easy today with this shot. Only 30 metres out. He'll be 2 points down if he kicks this goal. And it looks pretty good. He's happy. It's a goal, all right. So excellent football by big Ilya Grigic.
But I think it's a great example of his value to the side. He's the only one in the team in the AFL's 35 players out of the centre that rates a mention for the West Coast. He's been very workmanlike, and his effect across the half-forward area as well in kicking goals has been very good. As Masidi comes off, and O'Donnell back on, the Grigic certainly has taken all before him.
Strange one. 49 seconds to go in the term. O'Donnell back on the ground.
That often happens, Dennis, doesn't it? You don't know where the coach is going to look at the watch.
They must be burst players. Oh. Schofield out of the middle, down towards half forward. Donnelly didn't have it. He got the free, clock running down. We're down to 35 now. Time off has been whistled. It's on again. Donnelly meantime. As the ball bounced down towards the pocket. Fuster running out of space. Still he goes. Trying to get it to Cousins. Lucas thumps. Clock is running. Essendon's ally here, Banfield to Wooden, running away from goal to Morrison, back to Wooden, up towards the wing. Simmons has got it. They're down to 15 seconds now. It's in midfield. Kemp, great defence by the Bombers initially, but Kemp could punish them. Hitting a mark, the Eagles in from the side, prior the big leap. The crumbs to Morgan. The Bombers have weathered the storm, I fancy. Up towards the wing. McIntosh on the siren. Great stuff by Essendon late. Malthouse reasonably happy as well. We talked about that breeze. It is strong down the ground. As Adrian said, goals can be kicked in front of the three-tier stand, which does keep a lot of the breeze out once you get past half-forward going towards the western end. 2-4 to 3 goals at quarter time. And I suppose characteristic of the meetings between these two clubs. They're hard, and certainly early on, not a lot of scoring. We didn't expect that today. Generally, in the past, it's been the Bombers who've been able to break the games open. They have a wonderful record against the Eagles. 14-7. Quarter time, 2-4 to 3 goals. The Bombers on top.
If the house is rocking, don't bother knocking. If the house is rocking, don't bother knocking. Just step right in.
Got a time. Essendon lead by 2 points. Three straight goals to 2-4. Hurd, Pryor, Alessio have the goals for the Bombers and for the Eagles, Kemp and Grigich.
The 1997 AFL Premiership season. Proudly brought to you by Foster's Light Ice. For extreme refreshment. Telstra. Making life easier. Qantas. The Australian airline. And McDonald's.
Ready then for the start of the second term. Adrian?
Yeah, Dennis, very interesting in the Bombers camp. Their assistant coach, David Whedon, warms up the troops, does most of the talking early, and then Sheeds comes in. They're very unhappy with their use of the breeze. They know they should have kicked more goals. Over at the Eagles, they keep talking about their reasons for winning. Peter Matera's 150th, Andy Lovell's father passing away, and last year's drubbing in the final.
They're needing a win. Away they go. Lewis. Taken high, was he? I think so. He'll get the free. Chris Lewis inside the centre square. Broke his arm against the Bombers in the 95 qualifying final. Reported in the same incident. Here's Jakovic. Down the ground. He's about 60 metres out. Well shepherded by Fuster. Puts it high. Off hands. Opportunity for Doolin. Falling to the ground. Did well. Danaher to Hardwick. To Wellman outside the 50. Bounces to midfield. Grigich sends it back. Floating kick, Doolin camped in front, good grab too. Matera behind him, Doolin spreading his body in front to mark on the chest.
Looks like the Eagles have taken Jakovic off Alessio, put him on O'Connor at centre-half back. Turnbull's gone back to Alessio on the pocket.
Doolin, his best effort. Well played by O'Donnell to Somerville. And they've got some time. Morgan under pressure, floats the kick towards Grigich again, knocked it away. Well played too by Blumfield, sliding in McKenna. Created space there for Schofield, twisting and turning. Jared Schofield forward of the wing, back inside the 50. Matera, awkward half volley. Doolin controlled it brilliantly to his own advantage. In slides Kemp, on his knees Wellman, played it well. Got it across to Morgan, and they'll bring it out. Oh, low, the kick was too tall. Chance for Wooden. Wooden pulls it back, it floats towards the boundary, and goes across on the full. So Hardwick missed his target coming out. It's a chance to redeem himself.
Number 13 you see there on screen is Josh Wooden. And, well, Jason Ball doesn't look too good to me. He's warming up around the boundary line. That's Danaher getting it to Lucas. Or Lucas kicks it straight towards the boundary and over. So what's the report on Jason Ball, Adrian?
Yeah, but you've caught it perfectly. He's not looking too good at all. He's had his ankle re-strapped and he's trying to get warmed up, but he's not looking good. I don't know if he'll come back on.
Well, he was hobbling around the boundary line a couple of minutes ago and certainly he'd be very doubtful. Now, McIntosh, been told to straighten up on the mark. Now he's going to drive it. Oh, he's gone for that big torpedo punt kick of his. It's a beauty too. Nice mark, though, taken by Pryor. Although it was uncontested in the finish.
It was. I mean, it's the only player to read it well, so it was a great effort by Pryor, and I was just standing back spectating.
Well, there's Ben Doolin working very hard in defence. Lewis is moving well. He's, I think Chris Lewis has really matured as a player. Roscoe?
Yes, he's had a terrific season, Pete. 6-5 so far today as well, so he's continuing on getting the footy and being constructive.
Well, he's not getting into those stupid fights that he used to get into.
Played the ball, yes.
And he's getting on with the game, and he's a much better player for it. There's O'Donnell, and it's over the line again. The Bombers lead by 2 points, and as has been well documented, they've got a great record against the West Coast Eagles. They need a win here too, Essendon. Kemp knocks it out. Fletcher. Good play by the big football guy. He went for the boundary line. Wooden. Oh, kicked in there by Lewis. No kicking in danger, said the umpire. Rigic comes out very, very hard. Doolan's in after it. And, well, Essendon are going in pretty hard in this match too.
Yes, but just at the opposite end of the ground, just an observation for you that Kevin Sheedy's trying to drag Glenn Jakovic back away from the play out of centre-half back, so he's pushed O'Connor right into the square. Jakovic has to go back down to him because Alessio's there as well with Turnbull.
Well, there's Morgan. Oh, good play by Cousins. Terrific football. Oh, what great balance.
I said earlier, Pete, that he's had a much better start to the game than he has in previous weeks. Still under pressure, but he's had a bit of the footy. 4-4 so far. This is clever stuff. Out of the throw, and again, Rigic's in port just with his height to get the footy. And then to steal the ball, get up, having fallen to the ground, and still find the goals. Well played, Ben Cousins.
West Coast now in front by 4 points after that goal to that talented little forward pocket come Rover, come everything. Cousins, he's a terrific little footballer. Well done by Somerville. Get it to Denham. Oh, great mark. Fraser Gehrig over the back. And off he goes. He is an exciting player when he gets running with that ball. He elects to give it out to Chris Lewis. Lewis will go forward for the Eagles again. It's a wobbly kick to the half-forward line. The bounce, very important here. Taken by Doolan, who's having a very good term. On to Morgan. He's looking for Denham, but Denham, it was a poor kick because it's too small. And it's given over there by Donnelly to Lewis. Up towards the full forward area. A nice mark taken by Brendan Fuster over the back. And he should score a goal from here.
Yes, he's just warmed to the game, Pete. He's been out of it for so long. And just with those knee problems, he's been a fantastic effort to come back into senior football. Had his hands on the ball a bit in the first quarter, couldn't quite take marks, but that's a beauty.
So Fuster from directly in front has kicked the goal. So the Eagles in this last couple of minutes getting on top, they lead by 10 points.
Yes, and he just had the three games last year under booty, Brendan Fuster, but as I mentioned, those knee reconstructions just causing him problems. Good mark by Don. It's a wayward kick by Morgan, a dangerous one. Then Lewis looking for distance with a torque. Well played, particularly on someone like Lucas, because he's a very good mark himself. O'Connor's been taken off by Sheedy. Barnard back to the full forward area, picked up by Jakovic.
Margin out to 10 points then. Brigich decisively. Schofield taken high. We've got the three. He's been very good so far. Plenty of time. Gehrig sending him around his left foot. In other words, half forward. Well-weighted kick. Fuster has it. 65 metres out. Fuster. Got a good kick. Almost the mark, though, in the pocket to Grigic. Live ball down there. On his knees, Somerville did well. Under pressure, Hardwick throws it on the boot. Awkward bounce for Fuster. Across the line.
Yes, and Brian Wood, the Essendon runner, I'm sure would be saying to James Head, you've got to be very wary of Gehrig running off. You've got to pick him up.
Fletcher to Denham. Denham from half-back up towards the wing. Hurd. It's in front. And ricochets about 15 metres in the wrong direction. Wellman to Denham to O'Donnell. The runners combining. O'Donnell towards half-forward. Listed away by Jakovic from Lloyd. Banfield. Unkind bounce. Lloyd did well for the Bombers. In trouble now as he carried forward. Not according to the umpire. We'll have a bounce. The attack inside of right centre wing.
Well, Jakovic tackled Ola Renshaw from behind and pushed him into Lloyd, so there was two free kicks. Jakovic now picking up Lloyd with McIntosh going back into Barnard.
Centre wing, and Jerry will do the ruck work against Hurd. Well done by James Hurd. Almost holding the ball in the finish, but he gets it to O'Donnell. In towards Alessio, yes! Too big. And he is a vital player in the context of this game, Roscoe Alessio.
Yes, and those little swaps by Sheedy so far to unsettle the matchup of Jakovic on Alessio and Turnbull on O'Connor's worked pretty well so far.
So Stephen Alessio has already kicked the goal. That is a pretty accurate kick normally too. He's kicking into the breeze this time though from 35 metres. And he's under pressure from the crowd. So they're trying to put him off. Stabs. And he is goal. Lovely kick by Stephen Alessio for his second.
That's a pretty good indication, Pete. The breeze just dropped a little bit, certainly from that area where you're about 45 in front. As you look at her, just clever play here, just kept the ball alive, got quick hands onto O'Donnell. That's the Alessio mark, but kicking into that three-tiered stand area, it is pretty protected, so you should still get your distance if you give the ball the right trajectory.
Shadows there of the light pylon. They bounce it up. In the centre circle, of course. O'Donnell down towards half forward. Coming hard was Lloyd. Hurd getting into it now. Forward of the wing. Poor kick though. Lewis read it pretty well but left it behind. Wellman back to Hurd. Had it a long time to Lloyd. Lloyd from about 75 metres out. Down towards full forward. Off hands. Gathered by McIntosh. McIntosh breaks away with Dash. Back towards the wing. Griggage did nicely, got rid of Somerville.
A fight on here too.
Meantime, Somerville down towards half forward. Donnelly was up. Morgan spins out of trouble brilliantly. Doolan comes away. The fight, I think, Lewis and Hurd is the ball. Right. Meantime, towards half forward. Renshaw was taken high.
Yeah, had to be a free kick, Dennis. Sorry to jump in. Dennis Frisch let it go, but Grant
gave it away to Renshaw. Strong shepherd by Jakovic. Matera, meantime, bouncing down the ground, goes to his brother, so Peter to Philip. Philip Matera, just forward of the wing. Bright sunshine now at Subiaco Oval. The crowd getting into this game. Matera, miscues slightly, Fletcher. His chest.
I mentioned about Chris Lewis not getting into fights before. There he was, boxing on with James Hurd.
Somerville. Bounces, and again, up to half-back. Olerenshaw provides the lead. Matera, great closing speed, got there over the last couple of paces. Olerenshaw was down. Matera kicks to half-forward. They need to keep it in. They've done that. Fuster, the chance to go to Kemp. Kemp could shoot at goal right here. Kemp deep in the pocket. He's normally a good finisher. Misses to the near side this time. Never really gave it a chance.
Yes, I think Olerenshaw might be coming off too because the physio was out to see him earlier just before he had to run almost the full distance across the ground for that contest and gave up pretty easily in the end, so there's a problem there.
Now Fletcher has kicked in beautifully here to Chris Danaher. And Danaher couldn't really have anyone to get to it. And that's a nice mark taken by Josh Wooden. Thought the Essendon players hesitated then. Now, Doc Reid, the Essendon doctor, is going out to see Olerenshaw as Wooden races down towards Fuster. Fuster, oh, good play by Fletcher to thump it away, but Simmons was waiting for it. He read that beautifully. Bends it back. Oh, was that a push in the back? Philip Matera on Doolan. Matera kicks, and he has goal. I thought there was a push out. So Matera's kicked his first. West Coast 5-5 leads Essendon 4 straight. Maybe a little nudge.
Perhaps a little. People probably see that again as Olerenshaw did come off the ground. Simmons, who's been reasonably busy today, 5-4. Just a bit of a nudge. The three umpires allowing that. Goal results.
Final 5-4 straight. Evans on the ground now. Meanwhile, back in the middle, Schofield breaks away, kicks inside the 50. Morgan was up, missed it. Schofield leads back in the race, controlled it brilliantly. Well done. Great poise by Fletcher there, falling to the ground. Knocked it out of bounds. Adrian?
Yes, Dennis. Ola Renshaw has a hit on his right knee and he's being assessed. It doesn't look too good at the moment. I don't know if he'll come back on. But, Dennis, the atmosphere down here has really picked up, especially since Hurd versus Lewis box on. I think James Hurd is getting a bit frustrated that Fraser Gehrig is really shutting him down at the moment.
Got a bounce about 25 metres out from the Eagles' attacking goal. 10 scoring shots to 4. Well, Renshaw, worse for wear there. Not the look of a happy man, just trying to stretch it out. Meantime, we've got this bounce. What's happening? Kemp dragged down and buried. Another bounce. By Nichols. A lot of blocking off the ball. Hardwick, half chance. Tackled by Danaher. Round one ball. Jakovic, deftly done. Got it to Donnelly. His snap floats just wide of the goal. Awkward one for Fletcher. The ball swirling on him. Elite, quick thinking, as was the case with Jakovic before it.
Well, 11 scoring shots to 4 at the moment. So the Eagles have had most of the play. Lucas receives from Fletcher. Oh, a dangerous kick. It might come off. I know the mark is dropped there by Denham. Well played by Morris. I was giving it straight to Fraser. This is Gary O'Donnell. Low trajectory kick. Oh, reading it beautifully was McIntosh. And he drives it to half forward. Out came Cousins. Now Jakovic, can he kick a goal? He bends it back, it'll bring the house down if he can put it through, but he can't. He can only kick another behind, so the Eagles wasting opportunities, 5-7 to Essendon 4 straight.
Yes, and Jakovic is up there because Lucas has gone for a bit of a run on the ball, and now Sheedy will try and attract him back to the back half. He's brought O'Connor back on, Barnard off, which means Banfield's picking up O'Connor on a mismatch.
Pryor around the outer side, Simmons with great courage went back after it. Fraser sockers it forward, down towards left half forward for the Bombers. Simmons, and with him out there is Blumfield. Blumfield dragged off it. Simmons wins the day. Great chase, kicking towards half forward. Morgan works off his man, takes the mark, squares the ball. Trying to bring it up the ground again. Fletcher, Lucas through half back. Lucas in two minds, awkward for O'Donnell. Slaps it back, trying to get the ball into the path of Lucas. No free kick. Lewis clearly pushed in the back as the kick goes inside the 50. The forgotten rule, a push in the back. Down goes McKenna, Matera. Gehrig, did he have it? They battle after it. Wooden taken front on by O'Connor, a strong man. He flung him away. Matera, though, onto the crumbs. Great evasion. Too nimble there for Alessio. A second bounce and a third. Up to left half back, kicks towards the wing. Donnelly the slip. Now he's got company out, number 3-on-1. Well played by Wellman. In trouble, Danaher. Hand passed it to Donnelly. Across it comes to Turnbull. Turnbull down towards half forward. Fuster has it, or is it Jakovic? It's Jakovic. Jakovic runs towards the 50. The meat and the sandwich. He stayed on his feet, kicks inside the 50. Morgan takes the mark and comes away.
A very gutsy mark there by Morgan. Plays that one by Lewis. Good play by Chris Lewis. Goes outside. This is Josh Wooden driving it to the half forward line, racing after this. Tony Evans is on the go. Oh, look at the pace of Fletcher. Fantastic. On the left foot, out to Pryor. And Nick's goal is very important in this game. The Bombers try and belt it forward again. Oh, McKenna read that beautifully. Guy McKenna went for the precision kick. Oh, they've got the loose man going here.
Evans,
Morrison.
Sure.
Yep, he can go for Evans. Oh, he set it up high. Was that a push in the back? It was.
And they didn't see the previous one, Pete. That's unbelievable to Lewis. Goodness me.
Well, he's paid it to Evans, and Evans will drive it up in front of... Oh, is that a mark? Yes, it deserved it. And that's a little Morgan again. He's a gutsy little fella. Well done, Denny Morgan. On to Pryor. Ordinary kick by Michael Pryor. This is... Schofield, Denham's after him. Two pretty similar type players there, and you don't get an easy kick on Denham.
Sean Denham, 7 possessions today, averaging 20 for the season, very consistent. He averaged 20 last year and 21 back in 95. There he is. Schofield having a good afternoon. Probably the better of that duel so far. Running with Denham and getting some of the ball. Here's Kemp, debriefed. The ball comes down towards the 50. Danaher could have been taken high, was he? Battles after the ball. Donnelly jumps into his back. And there's no kick. So ball up on the 50.
There's Danaher playing the ball. Just trying to keep control of it.
Grigic, meantime, knocks it down. Jakovic, twisting and turning on the 50. Floats it towards full court. Great grab taken behind by Fuster. And when you consider the quality of the opposition there, Dustin Fletcher, that is a terrific mark.
Yes, and the impact of Jakovic in that forward half has been very important. Lucas is really running out of gas, finding it very hard to keep up with him.
Fuster runs around, hooks. He has to the near side. That breeze is very strong now, looking at the windsock behind the goal. It's fully extended directly down the ground, and that aided Fuster in taking that last grab. It carried a couple of meters more than the wily Fletcher anticipated, because Fletcher normally so good one-on-one. Hardwick back to Fletcher. Fletcher goes short. There's Denham in the pocket.
That familiar short kicking of Essendon. Again, they take it across the ground. This is Hardwick, Doolan. But, gee, they've been let off the hook a little bit here with the Eagles' poor kicking. Here's James Hurd. Oh, that is a clever mark. So Hurd is on the half-back line. He hooks it across the ground. There's only one player there. It's Simmons, so he gets a poor bounce. Lloyd missed it also. Here's Simmons again. He's an improved player on the Grigic. So the former Footscray ruckman brings it into the full forward area. Here's Lucas. Well played. Doolan. Oh, he's kicked it out in the full now. And it'll be a penalty kick to Ben Cousins. He's way out at half forward. Or is it going the umpire? Telling Fraser Gehrig he has to take that penalty kick. Now he shoots it across to Kemp. Now it's going to be brought back. So Fraser Gehrig's got the big job on James Hurd and doing fairly well at the moment. Matthew Lloyd coming off the ground and Paul Barnard on as Gehrig kicks to the half forward area. No mark taken. Here's Grigic. Oh, should be a free kick to Hardwick. Not paid. Well, I don't know, they're letting a lot go. Playing the... there's the Bomber bench. There's Matthew Lloyd, right of screen. Justin Blumfield there and Ricky Ollerinshaw.
Hurd dragged down. Tackle did slip high, but late. Gehrig has done a terrific job there. Hurd shaping coming in as the potential match winner. Still might, of course, win this one. Blumfield on the phone. Grigic has been very good, lays the ball into the path of Cousins. Cousins from 25 out has kicked the goal, his second. We can't speak too highly of Leo Grigic. He does what he's supposed to do around the ground. He takes the mark you expect him to mark, and this time makes a goal.
Yeah, I agree with it. Just that the added dimension he's given the side with his height. It's just made all the difference, whether it be in the midfield or his ability to read the play and get into the forward line or set something up like that. Ben Cousins had a much better game today so far. A couple of goals.
Well, you wouldn't believe this is the Eagles team that was so dismal against Richmond at the MCG. They grow a leg over here. Schofield bending it around. Now, what's Morrison doing way out on his own? Danaher's after him. Well played by Chad Morrison. He's doing well. Here's Jakovic. Oh, he's getting some confidence. He might kick a goal here, Jakovic. Oh, great play. That's a top goal. And the crowd are up and roaring after one of their favourite sons kicks that great goal.
Yeah, so in leaving him at centre-half forward, it's been a good move because he's got around Lucas pretty easily. Danaher did the right thing by leaving his man to make the contest, but then Gary O'Donnell, with all his experience, watched the footy and not the body, just got faded too easily. But the finish was outstanding. And he's pretty excited. And he'll knock Ilya Grigic over on the way back.
How about that? Lynn Jakovic, outstanding goal. Peter touched on the point. Different team today from the one that lost on Monday Night Football. Different kettle of quiche this afternoon so far in the run-up to half-time. Schofield goes to ground. Sliding in there is Morgan. Bounce. So the Bombers need to control the damage right here. 3.5 minutes to go to half-time. The breeze whipping down the ground. And they're down by 26 points. Can't let it get out any further. A late goal would be nice, but no goals to the Eagles, possibly more important. Wooden slaps it out wide. Fraser under the pump. And the ball up. They didn't get value for effort, the Bombers, in the opening term. Down with the breeze, they won the toss. And that's been a pivotal duel. Aaron Hurd. Alongside the umpire, Grigic, clean possession. Kemp hurriedly. Hardwick back towards half forward. Massidi. Joe Massidi going for distance. Over Pryor's head. Alessio the target, and why not? He's got a couple already. Steve Alessio from just outside the 50. Won't get the distance. It'll drop almost directly down here now. Going back, the mark was missed. Opportunity off the deck. O'Connor has slipped it through for a behind. Young seemed to have that one. Actually, Guy McKenna forcing the behind, but I was watching Harry Young, who, to all intents and purposes, was going to take that mark, and then was off balance after he spilled it.
McIntosh finds Gehrig. He's off. Umpire calling him to play on, and he'll find Drew Banfield in the back half. Banfield's going to shoot this across because he can see McIntosh.
Matera from the other side of his team.
And he's also had a couple of options on that occasion. Also had Josh Wooden. Jakovic couldn't mark. He's Barry Young. And he could do with a couple of quick goals. This is Pryor. Into half or good mark to Ryan O'Connor. He's got to turn around and get out. Barnard's one out if he kicks it now. He's on McKenna. He's going to go for the long bomb. And it's a wobbly punt kick. Barnard in front was good play. Hurd, the dangerous Hurd, has got it, but he's surrounded by Eagles. And he couldn't break clear. And umpire Dennis Richard coming and bounce.
Yes, Hurd looking for a free kick for a high tackle. But given some of the free kicks they haven't played, they wouldn't have played that one.
So a bounce about 15 metres out. Bombers attacking goal. Just over a minute to go to half-time. McKenna storming through. Well played. Goes towards the outer side. It pitches just inside the field of play and bounces across the line. And McKenna played his 200th last Monday as we go down to the boundary.
Dennis, just from news from ground level, Ola Renshaw is okay. I think he'll come back onto the second half. And James Hurd and Fraser Gehrig, I think Gehrig's taken a leaf out of Coughlin's book from last week. I think Hurd's going to be in for a big month with players playing on him like that.
Turnbull comes away. Still got a way to go, I think, to catch up to Glenn. Glenn really worked him over, but he's playing him very close as Gehrig, as the kick comes from Hardwick. Hurd lays it off. Morgan is about 75 metres out in short, intended for Young, and that's better. On the chest, Barry Young will kick it goal from about, I suppose, 45 out. Don't like his chances from here, although he is a powerful kick. Somerville headed down in that direction. Grigic going with him. Alessio in short offers, but Young likes his chances. That's not a bad effort. I think he may have got the goal. He has. Terrific.
You've coached a couple through today, Dennis. No, it was a very good kick, and it's an important one for them. They really had lost their way for a while, and all the play was with the West Coast, and they struggled so much when they went forward in that area because Hurd, predominantly this quarter, has been playing down the ground, and where he got his kicks, he was kicking the area that he really should have been.
Actually, when you look at the windsock and the stand, that was the perfect spot, wasn't it?
So just about half time after that lovely kick to Barry Young. Just keeps Essendon in there. The Eagles have been well on top in this term. Alessio against Grigic. Well played by Big Alessio. Kicked away by Kemp. Taken by Jakovic. Beautiful hand pass to Morrison. Just outside 50. Sets sail for goal. And helped on its way by Dustin Fletcher for a behind.
If the scores remain as they are, Pete, so without another goal coming on, 5-2 with the breeze is about what you'd look for.
So Dustin Fletcher to bring it back in, and he has found Wellman as the siren sounds. Ross, to end the quarter where really the Eagles could have been a lot further in front.
They could very much have been, and they will probably be aware of that, but I think the move that made the difference was Jakovic going to that half-forward area and controlling centre-half forward. And that goalie kick was a real lifter, but just getting possessions and making sure that Lucas was nowhere near him. And conversely, the effort of Gehrig. Playing Hurd, not unlike he's been played before, but perhaps the athleticism of Gehrig and his pace is something that Hurd hasn't encountered before, so it's made him play up the ground. Alessio, not quite the impact in this quarter as he was in the first, but still going to be, I think, Essendon a chance in this third quarter in Port to use that breeze.
Yes, that third one very important for the Bombers. They trail at half-time, 5-1-7-9.
If the house is rocking, don't buy the knocking. If the house is rocking, don't buy the knocking. Just step right in and let the fun begin.
Half-time in the West Coast, Eagles led it by 20 points in this match, living up to its billing. 7-9-5-1 after Essendon had first use of the breeze and led by 2 points at quarter time. Ben Cousins, 2 goals in that term, and Steve Alessio has 2 to the major break for the Bombers. And just a reminder, it's Monday night for Talking Footy. Join Bruce, Lee and Mike right here on 7. Everybody's
talking at me. What was the old days?
Well, the old days, if you get the kick, you're going to get it.
Happy with the umpiring this year?
Don't we just want umpires out there who are umpires? We don't want personalities. I mean, they're just umpires. I mean, they're there to blow the whistle. Do we want to be able to separate them?
They were more personalities in the old days than they are now.
Well, that was because there's one of them. There's 3 out there now, so there's a third of the personality in each. That's some basic mathematics, isn't it?
Blighty never said anything that stupid all the time we're sitting on the desk.
Well, it's a laugher. Yes, Talking Footy around the country each and every Monday night. Check your local guides. Well, at Waverley this afternoon, 2 sides with almost identical records, St Kilda and the Tigers going at it. Here's some of the second half action.
Who's got the job on Ozzie Jones at the moment? Naish has kicked 2 goals, loves to get back into the goal scoring area. A little bit too far out the score, but it bounces and it bounces and it hit the post, or did it? It might have rolled over without hitting it. It has. Dropped his second mark.
Ozzie Jones on the burst, open goal for Saints. Good reply.
They've won it at midfield, importantly. Holland tries to paddle it forward. Now, that's not a bad sort of a snap. That's a goal from Harvey.
David Burke over the top. Good jump. Nichols on his right boot. Screws around. The Tigers love it. So does Trent Nichols.
Umpire says you can go back and take your kicks up, which he does. Low again. 45 metres out. Slight angle. It's there. Goal umpire hasn't moved. Point the difference.
Bit of pace from Jones. Good shepherd work. Good communication. Now to Lappin. Back to Jones. Great work from the Saints. Jones can bounce once. He's got Ziller up forward. It's Heatley.
From about 50 metres on a pretty tight angle.
Oh!
Great kick from Jason Heatley.
Thank you, Jason. Takes the grab. Centering kick. Down to Stewie Lowe territory, but it's not Lowe. It's Heatley. But Heatley directly in front. He'll get the distance. And he's got the accuracy. Great start for the Shangers in the final quarter. May prove costly. Let's wait and see. Gasper has it paddled away from him. In a goal, Brown, and he's kicked it!
Had Harvey's measure in the first half. Burke back on the ground. Now's a chance for Burke. Beautifully caught by Hutchton. Open to get his kick. A goal for the Tigers. They're back in it.
Very important game, close to full time at Waverley. And the Saints, as you can see, in front. About 10 minutes, we're told, to play. 17-8 to 13-9. We'll bring you a final a little bit later on. Meantime, half-time right here at Subi. It's the West Coast Eagles up by 20 points. We'll be back shortly.
If the house is rocking, don't bother knocking. If the house is rocking, don't bother knocking. Just step right in.
Sellout crowd on what is a beautiful day now. It was threatening earlier today, 19 degrees currently. The game in a nutshell. Jason Ball started well, hurt his ankle. James Hurd, well held so far. And the West Coast Eagles kicking 5 goals, 5 in that second term, running on the westerly breeze. Well, in recent seasons, North Melbourne has had a terrific record against the Western Bulldogs. In fact, they've won their last 5 clashes. They're playing this afternoon at the MCG. Let's take a peek.
Good shepherd.
He's got to turn it back in.
Great work.
Hudson.
Well done.
We'll be talking a one-man team after this, perhaps. Hudson, a good hand pass. Romero on the 50. Well played, Collingwood, just back on. Out in front of Minden Connell.
Oh, that's an excellent lead, Ned.
This reached third.
Great kick.
Here's Mellington on the bounce to Stevens. Dispossessed and then regains it. Sun in the eyes. Good mark. Robert Scott. Well, here's Robert Scott for the Kangaroos' first goal since the second quarter. That was a great kick by Ellis across the ground.
Look at Smith work into there.
Yep, Rowan Smith cutting him up with his running.
Harry's quarter-by-quarter stats. He's been great all day, and he's got a goal to add to those now. Terrific result.
And they're still playing at the MCG. We'll check the final there. Didn't pick them again today. I can't believe that. Every week they go without me when they win. The Western Bulldogs 15-7-97, leading North Melbourne 10-10-70. And if you barrack for North, not enough time to get back into that one. Here at Subi, can the Bombers get back? They're down by 20 points. We'll be back to find out right after this. If the house is rocking.
back at Subi. West Coast Eagles leading 7-9, 51-5, 1-31. Big second term. Not much between them as we can see. Essendon 39 marks to 30, but a lot of chipping around. 9 free kicks in our game. Western Bulldogs, well, they bounce back, coming off their loss against Collingwood, 16-7, 103 to 10-11, 71. Saw North last week when they won, they weren't that impressive. Another loss today, so they're just marking time. Not the powerhouse we expected, of course, they're missing a great player, but North Melbourne would be disappointed with that result. Let's go down to Adrian Barrage.
Yes, Dennis, I've got the jacket, actually, that we're going to present to the winning coach, hopefully, after the game, made by Channel 7. Got all the recent games on there. The record at the moment is 6-8 to the Bombers, and hopefully, well, one of the teams will be on the bottom there. Sheeds has asked me to try it out, actually, so if you don't mind, I'll just test it out and test its weight out. Just one sec. Here you go. Like it. They're all getting ready actually with their scarves and that in case the Eagles boys win. Also thought I'd tell our viewers a few of the stories that have come out of this great rivalry, apart from the windsock being tied down at Windy Hill once. But one of the most famous stories is Kevin Sheedy relating the Tiananmen Square China riots in China to the Eagle. Remember that scene where the tank is approaching a lone protester? Well, the tank was the bomber, was the Eagles. The lone protester was, of course, the Bombers, and it was a sort of a east versus west thing. That was one of the great build-ups they had. The other one was two magnetic boards. Kevin Sheedy once had two magnetic boards. One that he would show up in the coach's box up there. He'd have it in a prominent position where Mick Moldes could see the board and peer through the window and see the lineups. But in fact, they were their incorrect lineups. He had his other lineups hiding somewhere else. So just incredible things that have happened between these two, mainly to upset the coaches, I think. They're mainly trying to put each other off. If he walks past, I'll grab him and talk him about it. But later on, we're going to talk to Sheeds or Mick, depending on who wins, and present him with this fantastic Channel 7 jacket.
What can I say, Adrian? I feel as though I've been through the Smithsonian. Terrific. 7-9 to 5-1. Kevin Sheedy around the boundary line. And I think amongst rival coaches, he's one of the most liked here in Perth. He really has been a strong supporter of interstate football long before it was fashionable, and I think a lot of the rivalry is good-natured when the West Australians get on his back. Of course, he's got other things to worry about right here. There he is. Media-friendly, Kevin Sheedy.
Well, he wasn't so friendly to play against, I must say, Dennis, when he was in the back pocket and you were playing full forward, he'd try anything to put you up, but he was a fantastic player for Richmond. He made himself into a state player and a really top class footballer.
Just a hard man, wasn't he? Hard doer on the field because he wasn't quick. Nothing about him set him apart, but it was all about attitude and his career.
But just looking the way the players are starting to settle down for the start of this third quarter, Jakovic has gone to the back half again, having been so prominent forward in that second quarter. Banfield at the moment is around centre half forward, being picked up by Scotty Lucas. So there's a mismatch there that the Bombers want to try and change.
Start of the third term, very congested, way to the left on the Bombers' forward line. They've all congregated around centre-half forward. Anyway, Grigich goes up. He's been pretty good this afternoon. Fraser missed the ball. Grigich with the body got rid of him. Kemp dragged down. Dean Kemp with the ball. Bad first half, but 9 possessions by his standards. Not outstanding. In fact, in the last two games against the Bombers, he's 27 possessions. Chewy on the ball, as distinct from chewy on your boot. So now a bounce just wide of the centre circle. Circling Somerville, trying to get a run at that one. Falls at the ruckman's feet. Somerville helps it on its way, but only as far as Cousins. Cousins down towards the half forward line. Donnelly was up. Barnard slapping away. It stays in, at least initially, and now it's across the line.
So a very important quarter of football coming up here, particularly as far as Essendon is concerned. Kicking with the breeze. They certainly have to be up with the Eagles at three-quarter time. Somerville got his hands to it, to Denham. Broke the tackle, and Denham whips it around the boundary line. Banfield went past it. Oh, good pace here by Fraser. In towards the full forward area. The bounce very important here. Taken by Peter Matera. There's Hardwick, smothered off the boot. Guy McKenna's after it. Ever reliable Guy McKenna. Lays off a hand pass to McIntosh. McIntosh tries to bend it back. Dangerous, but Matera's good enough to go in and take the mark against Barry Young. He is a very brilliant player, Peter Matera. Low trajectory kick. Good play by little Danny Morgan, who was excellent. Roscoe, in that second term.
Yes, and that kick from McIntosh was the idea was right, Peter. It's just made to look very good by the efforts of Matera.
So way out at half forward for the Bombers. They trail 7-9 to 5-1. Rigic. Well, Chris Danaher's taking him on. Denham was there. Here's Ben Cousins, exciting player, onto Jared Schofield. Schofield to half forward. Barnard in front. He went without it. Lucas there to mop up. And Lucas trying to get onto his left boot. A high floating kick to the half forward line. They need someone to take a mark. Good play by Hardwick. Gets it out to Hurd. Hurd can pop away a goal. Oh, he's blasted it wide. He's missed. And really should have kicked that one, James Hurd.
Well, that's the standard he sets, Pete, isn't it? He's had 7-4, so it hasn't been a poor day by any means. He just had that extra pressure put on by Gerrig. Jakovic has now come back down to centre-half forward. Picked up by Lucas. McIntosh picks up O'Connor.
Even the great ones can feel it. Some inferred pressure there. Hurd had more time than he thought. He's quick to put it on the boot. Here's McKenna. Towards half-back. Rigic almost, it falls behind, Morgan to Hurd again, he's about 65 metres from goal, sets it up, they'll contest about 25 metres out, Turnbull knocked it away, Denham on the ground, sprays it wide. Valuable opportunities being squandered right here, they've got to go with the breeze and take advantage of it. Matera to McIntosh, and he runs away, McIntosh. The opposite side of the ground, kicking up towards the wing. Kemp storming up, takes the mark on his chest. Where is the next piece of the puzzle? He looks upfield, not much happening. Now Donnelly moves for him. It goes in that direction. Awkward half volley. Comes off Donnelly's boot. The bounds on the full, so Ruth Bernard will take the free kick on the outer side. Kicks it back towards the wing. That was a poor kick. McKenna with dash. Kicks to half forward and Lewis. They will afford a goal here, the Bombers. Against the trend of play, Lewis about 75 metres out, pops it up. Fuster missed it. Close to the boundary line, it's a cross. He'll be throwing in. Brendan Fuster started brilliantly last season. Then was dropped by the West Coast Eagles. Injured his knee, needed a reconstruction when he went back to play for West Perth. Rejoined that club last week. Rushed back into the Eagles squad. Wellman stood up in the tackle. O'Donnell to Somerville. Somerville gives it away. Morrison unloads from 60. Up in front, Fletcher. Ball spilt. Over the ball, Wellman. He had that ball surrounded. Is that holding the ball? It's very close. I think if you were to conduct a straw poll and ask Glenn Jakovic, he'd probably say it was holding the ball.
I think it would have been a very poor decision if they had have paid that, because they haven't been paying them all day for similar things. Right in front of goal. The Eagles' goal, that is. Good hit out. Comes to Wellman. Wellman finds Chris Danaher. Good play by Wellman. A follow-up and drive it to centre wing. But McKenna waits underneath. Geez, a good save play. Oh, a look-away hand punch. And Gerry wasn't quite ready for it. But he eventually gets it across to Grigic. Off he goes. Drives it with a nice long kick. Somerville read it well. Peter Somerville has come back across the ground. This is Fletcher. Fletcher looking for Steve Alessio. Doolin's there also. Now, oh, what a pickup by the big fella. 6'6". Bindy it back to O'Connor. Good mark. Fraser, oh, his awareness wasn't good then. It was a poor hand pass because he was covered. Morrison, oh, good tackle. O'Connor, they've got the loose man going here. Now, they should score a goal here. He can give it across to Hurd. He can. He's going to chip it across now, and Hurd will run into an open goal. A gimme goal coming up here to James Hurd, and he's popped it through.
Hurdles kick two, and well, that was a the crowd were hooting the umpires, but it was a good piece of play there by the Bombers.
Yes, and it was all set up by the effort, Alessio just picking that ball up and just centering the ball. And then the second effort by O'Connor, and that's the advantage where it was paid. Gelato, Chris Donnelly, Danaher to go forward. Gehrig did the right thing, came towards Danaher, but then had to go back and chase Hurd. Couldn't quite back there in time, and the goal results.
So the Bombers creep back to within 13 points here. Needed that one. Terrific crowd. Subi bulging this afternoon. Grigic down towards half forward. Lucas pushed off the ball. Djakovic, as a result, in space. He's been very good on the forward line, Djakovic. From about 80 metres out, not a particularly good kick. It wanders down towards the pocket. Barnard tracks it back. It bounces away from him. And it will be thrown in.
I'm not sure what Glenn Djakovic saw when he turned around, because Lewis had run straight down towards centre-half forward towards the 50, which is where he was leading. Sorry, where his kick should have gone, but it came right around his body to no man's land.
Fuster, Somerville, Somerville with the run, won it down, Kemp, O'Donnell worked him off the ball, kicks it back towards half-back, tailor-made for the leap from behind, Cousins, Cousins 60 metres out, Djakovic drops back to the square, bear in mind this one should fall short, kicks it very high, it'll drop now, down it comes, Somerville and Lucas, Lucas got a fist on it, Denham roving the pack to Morgan. Morgan from half-back needs to be precise with the kick. Not a bad result for the Bombers. Massidi up, McKenna with him, out of bounds, out of side.
Yes, and that scenario is quite right, Dennis. The ball's always going to drop short, and what was poor by the Eagles' forwards, particularly their smaller players, no one at the fall of the ball.
It's only 13 points the margin. There's Matthew Lloyd getting some physio treatment. Alessio, worked his way under it. Wellman. Centre wing McKenna, oh, brilliant play by Guy McKenna. Simmons is a greatly improved player. On to McIntosh, a dangerous hand pass. Well played, Schofield. Oh, nearly caught. Griggs went without it. Somerville, Kemp. Schofield dragged off it when he didn't have the ball. Could have received the kick. And the umpire would come and bounce. Now, they might have found something here. There's a happy Bomber supporter. They are sneaking back into it.
Only 11 free kicks all day.
8 to Essendon. Sorry, Dennis. Yeah.
Only 3 to the Bombers.
Well, so I can't follow the argument. If you don't pay free kicks, the game is allowed to flow more. I mean, if they're there, you've just got to pay them. It doesn't matter if you pay 30 or 40.
So just outside the Eagles' 50-metre line, Somerville worked out of it by Grigic. Punched away by Lucas. Well played, Gary O'Donnell. Schofield runs into a brick wall. And they'll bounce it again. Umpire Kieran Nichols. Just one gets the feeling the Bombers are, well, they're not far out of it. And if they could get up with the Eagles by three-quarter time, I reckon they'll be very difficult to shake off. The amount of play the Eagles have had, they should be a lot further in front. There's Somerville. Denham trying to get a toe poke and, well, an ugly passage of play here this past minute.
Quite often, this is the legacy of not paying free kicks.
Quite right.
There's a lot of bounces. I think bounces would be up this season. Anyway, got 75 metres from goal. Somerville slaps it down. Simmons onto the loose ball. Momentarily inside the centre square. Kicks for space. Fuster set a task on the outer side. You'd expect Fletcher to be too nimble. Sliding in though, Philip Matera. Brilliant hand pass back towards Morrison. Morrison surrounded. Fletcher blocked him well. Danaher, that's ambitious, to his own advantage, off the deck. O'Donnell couldn't hang on. Now he's hung on to. Kemp dragged him down. Again, Danaher sockers it out towards the wing. Turnbull and Alessio left behind. Swooping on the loose ball is Fraser. Fraser bombs it long inside the 50. Matera! Oh, what a good mark. That was coming on the wind. And Matera, falling back, took it. Plays on immediately. Gehrig, loose men on the side of the ground for the Eagles. Banfield's got it. Runs up to half-back. Chips towards the wing. Grigic hands to it. Waiting in front. Morgan liked his game. O'Donnell off his step. Fires it back towards half-forward. Gehrig in from the side. Fraser Gehrig plays on immediately. Matera, averaging 24 possessions a game this season. That's five up from last year and the previous season. Turnbull to the outer side. Djakovic has got it. Yes, always on. Broke it and gets away. 85 metres out. Houston from behind. One hand. Only man standing is Donnelly. Sock it off the ground. Philip Matera goal.
That's the second time that the Eagles have scored a goal from a Fraser Gehrig mark in a pack situation across half-back. Just floating across and taking the ball out of the hands of other players. The resulting play-on situation sees Djakovic take that mark. He's always going to be too nimble in that situation. For Lucas, nearly a great effort by, nearly a great mark by Fuster. And that's what the score players like Matera are there for.
Well, a very handy goal that to the Eagles, and out lead by 19 points just when you felt the Bombers were getting back into it. Denham couldn't get through that pack. Denham still going out with it, and umpire Dennis Rich would come in and bounce it. Well, crunch time now for the Bombers as we see Ricky Ola-Renshaw warming up on the boundary line. Former Richmond champion Brian Wood, the runner, is running out to obviously going to replace someone. There's Kemp caught with the ball, and the umpire will bounce it again. So just outside, or just close to the edge of the centre square area, Alessio and Grigic. Grigic goes in, has another bounce here as Lewis crashes his way into the pack. Certainly Dennis Rich is earning his keep there, having to bounce it all the time. So Barry Young is the player coming off. He's been outpointed a couple of times here by Matera in one-on-one contests. And Ricky Ola-Renshaw races on. And going down to the forward line on Matera. So the bounce again, Grigic and Steve Alessio. Kemp went without it. Well, it's still locked in there. And another bounce. Take it away, Dennis.
Oh, thank you, Pete. Feel like a barrel girl. Yeah,
don't break into song, for goodness sake.
No, that's Pete's domain, that. So we've got a bounce inside the centre square. And a little lackluster at the moment. 8-9-6-2. Everything to play for, though. Alessio and Grigic in from the side. Djakovic, who's been inspirational on occasions. The man was held a long time. That was Schofield coming away as Lucas. Lucas inside the 50. Almost been a free kick to O'Connor down there. It was. Advantage pay. Herr unloads, bends it back. Great kick. What a beauty. His third.
Yes, and the advantage there, or the beauty of James Herr in that situation, is that he doesn't continue on his left, but he knows the preferred effort from that area to get back onto his right as soon as possible. Good effort by Lucas, actually, to get away and get good distance with his kick. O'Connor, a good effort to try and grab in. There's, watch this, steps to straighten. A lot of players would have kept going on their left. They had the ability to stop, turn, and then kick from that couple of steps. Great effort.
Well, again, the margin is 13 points after James Herr has kicked his third. After terrific play from Lucas. Now, that was Schofield kicking it forward. Gary O'Donnell onto his right, bends it back to Ricky Ola-Renshaw. Now, will it sit for him? He's got it. Matera. Oh, that's deliberate. And in fact, he was pinged for holding the ball, and he won't get round Matera. He was just too quick. He's like a cat.
You could almost sense that he knew that Matera was hot on him, and he just didn't know what to do.
Now, you can see that it went straight over the line. The umpire actually paid holding the ball. Morrison, Chris Lewis. Lewis waiting for Djakovic to move. Djakovic has moved, but he's just holding it up. Had about 8.5 minutes to three-quarter time. There's that short kick to Banfield. The Bombers have got them all covered down there, all the Eagles forwards. Alessio's gone down to pick up Grigic. And another short kick, Djakovic. He's about 70 metres out from goal. He's going to bomb this one in towards the square. Fuster. Oh, almost took it too.
still in the danger area. Donnelly shuffles it out. Oh, Cousins, was he caught high? Just gets a little toe-poke kick. Quick hand pass. Comes back here to Philip Matera. Simmons did well. The Bombers are trying to lay on the pressure. The quick kick by Evans. Down, oh, push out, was it? No, well. Another one locked down the other end. It's Philip Matera who's got it.
He's the master of that push, isn't he? And you watch it again. I mean, the arms are fully extended.
Yes. It's almost like you're just holding your ground. It's not a savage push. It's just one that allows you to take balance. It prevents the player coming back and crashing into you.
Well, it's exactly the same as he did down the other end. And you're right. He disguises it pretty well, Roscoe. Just a gentle nudge with the hands.
Ben Dillon, sick of it.
So, Philip Matera, a vital kick coming up. He's already kicked two, and he has kicked his third. So, the Eagles have the answers just when the Bombers start to look dangerous.
Yes, and the number of times the ball was handled since the effort of Houston to almost take the mark was quite incredible. Great recovery on a couple of occasions by Cousins to get the ball back, and then the ball filters from three or four different players, finishes up with Matera. See again, Banfield had the ball on the other side of the ground. That's all you need. Didn't push him forward, just allowed him to hold his ground.
Well, technically it's in the back, isn't it?
Well,
when your hands are in the guy's back. The hands are straight out in the back. It's got to be in the back, surely.
But it hasn't actually pushed him all the way forward, has it? It's just stopped him from coming back into the body.
Anyway, these days, in the back doesn't exist.
That's exactly right.
Back in the centre, Wellman, Schofield, had it a long time. Grigich feeds it wide. Peter Matera with dash through the wing. Fraser, though, is quick. Jakovic. Fraser bobs up and goes after him again. Jakovic chased by three. Bad footy. Banfield to Matera. Matera, I think he hit under a branch or a twig out there. He gives it across to Wooden. Wooden goes for home. Back goes Fletcher. Plays it against the goalpost. Matera's hurt. He was down and hurt.
Hope that's not a knee.
Oh, he may have got a kick on it.
No, he's okay.
Couldn't argue with my doctor, Pete. Danaher's got it. Left half back, and he's away.
So Chris Danaher down to Hurd and Gehrig. Gehrig's done all right, and yet, that's how good James Hurd is.
So we've got a boundary throw in on the wing. We saw that jacket at halftime. What does Kevin Chitty think about the jacket waving?
That's part of football, and you got to win and wear all that stuff, and that to me, probably in many ways, it's great for the game and the two clubs to have a ferocious competitive spirit against each other, and I see no reason why it should stop.
So you can bet there'll be some jacket waving if the Eagles happen to win this game. It's become part and parcel clashes between these two teams. Here's O'Connor on the Wellman, on the Denham. That's good play. Denham at goal. That's another one to the Bombers. Great kick. So Sean Denham's kicked his first on his non-preferred foot, and that was excellent football.
Well, magnificent control of the ball. The kick just coming out quickly with Hurd, the smother, all facets involved here, the ruck play, and then the ability of Denham to control the ball. The handball is just a smidge high. Control has avoided the tackle. And then the safe movement is straightening up, kicks a goal straight through the middle. Well done.
Well, a goal right there that would have had the MCG pulsating. Barely a ripple here at Subiaco Oval. What a great goal on the run by Denham. 6.5 minutes till three-quarter time. Margin 14 points. There's Denham again trying to flick it out. Down goes Cousins. Sliding in Morgan, spills back to Banfield, smothered off the boot, no concessions in there. Denham away to Alessio, off the side of the boot. It wanders out towards the wing. Olerenshaw and Matera. Matera held without it.
Oh,
play goes on. Here's Hurd. Hurd the hand pass across to Olerenshaw. Olerenshaw's got it a long time. Early in the season, of course, that was holding the ball. It comes across towards Wooden. I don't think either side will be happy with the umpiring this afternoon. There's McIntosh. McIntosh towards the wing. Cousins has to stretch and takes the mark on his chest. Up towards the wing goes the kick. Jakovic. I'm biting my tongue here, Roscoe.
I bet you are.
There's McKenna.
Careful enough to come off of the blood rule.
Cousins. across towards Kemp behind Barnard, close to the boundary line. A very important game like this deserves better. We've got a throw in. Adrian Barrage.
Dennis, I don't think we'll be seeing too much of Jason Ball again. He doesn't even warm up with the other Eagle interchange players. His ankle is pretty bad. It's a big blow to the flexibility of the team.
Good hand pass by Kemp to Jakovic. He's moving better with each game he plays. Jakovic, Fuster, and he can't control it. Because
it's off the full cleat.
Oh, it came off his boot. Yep. So it's a free kick to, thank you, Roscoe. As we see Dustin Fletcher. Oh, that's a free kick surely in the back. Against Lewis. Oh, goodness me.
It's a push in the back 3 day, I think.
Morrison. Morrison is marked in this. I can't believe that. Morrison.
Which one?
Simmons. Now the Eagles go forward again through Wooten. Oh, good kick. A delayed kick. He just tapped it gently in front. Didn't belt it. And latching onto it there, of course, was Ben Cousins.
He's already kicked a couple of goals, beating two important ones in that second quarter where they asserted themselves. He's been much busier today, 10 and 5 leading to this kick.
He's a very exciting player, Ross, isn't he?
People come to the football to watch these players, not to watch the players annoy them.
Well, you've got him there and you've got McKenna and Matera down the other end. Fantastic to watch. Here is a point, I think. I think he might have let Essendon off the hook. Get the feeling that they're dangerous, isn't it? I've been saying this for a while. Yeah. The Eagles just can't shake them off.
Yeah, they're inside 50 at the half time. Stats are well in advance what Essendon were. Pete just can't take advantage of it.
Fletcher kicks in. Alessio worked out of it. Banfield to Kemp in space. Sends it long down towards full forward. Over the top, Fuster. Now, we were talking before the game. I've really got a high opinion of this young player. I think that if the West Coast Eagles are going to take a run at the big time this season, he could be a surprise packet.
He's taken three great marks, hasn't he?
And he's spilled a few this afternoon as well, but he's getting his hands to them and controlling the marking contests. This one he finishes off. Goal.
Yes, and I don't think there's any doubt that's the important point. The fact is he's getting his hands on the ball, which means he's getting the right position, and the players are prepared to kick toward him, having the confidence that he will take a mark or at least make a contest. And that's what they haven't had for some time in that area. Someone who is confident above his head, has a size about him, can bustle a bit, and also kick the goal.
Well, again, the margin is 21 points. The Bombers just can't get within one kick. And Schofield, taken by Denham. A wobbly kick to half forward. Good pressure there. It was by McIntosh, and he goes out and he takes, with Hardwick, they take the ball over the line. Very, very quick player, Ashley McIntosh. Would be a difficult player to play on, I would suggest, if you're a full forward, because of that pace.
It's not the sort of player that Matthew Lloyd probably had playing against him either, Pete.
So Grigic, oh, Alessio is terrific. He's so mobile. To Hardwick. Heard that must be a free kick. He was the kicker goal bounces through anyway. It was a free kick to Heard. It had to be, surely.
Well, Dennis would seem to make the judgment well after the ball had gone past. If he'd allowed play to go on.
I thought the original free wasn't paid. Then it was a goal to Danaher, and then the free kick was paid after Danaher's kicked the goal.
Unless something happened to Hurd on the ground.
What's happened there?
Let's see this again. So Hurd makes an effort for a chest mark.
Bang.
No intent on McIntosh and the ball.
Got to be a free that.
Yeah, of course.
Then Danaher played on and kicked the goal.
But did the umpire award the kick?
No, well, I was watching him. I didn't think he did.
No, I was watching him. There was no call of advantage.
That was very strange. Anyway, Hurd's got it. And he has missed after Danaher had kicked the goal. So bad luck to the Bombers, eh?
Yep. Yeah, Dennis Rich certainly, as a senior umpire, seemed to be very confused there as to what to do. It's almost as if he paid the kick in the end after there'd be some query from players.
He certainly didn't seem to pay it when it happened.
No.
He's normally very good, Dennis Rich. Fraser Gehrig to himself. runs away. With pace and with troubles. Gets away from Hardwick, still he goes, Gearing, look at this. Off down the ground, Fraser, shepherded by Lewis. Ola Renshaw's not happy with Lewis, that's going on. Meantime, Jakovic has got the ball. Jakovic plays on. Some frustrations out there, not surprisingly. The ball wobbles towards the pocket. Well, Big Hilly has made himself invisible. He slipped in behind the defence, but misses the goal.
Came out of the shadows.
Where did he come from? Unmarked.
That was a fifth goalpost. But Jakovic has to be careful those kicks sometimes. They're all pulling from right to left. Try and straighten them up.
This is Pryor. Bombers to win this game. I reckon they'd have to get a goal here before three-quarter time. This is Lucas has got the big job on Jakovic. Jakovic is just moving so much better. Oh, look at that. Matera is just a different class out there at times. To Simmons, great kick by Matera. Simmons way out at half forward. He's going to bring it across, hoping they can take a mark. There's Fuster at the back. Oh, good grab.
It's exciting, isn't he?
Oh, he's a very good player, this boy.
Just knows where to go. And someone of that size with such clean hands, just so important to read it and take a grab like this. Another a knock for Ben Cousins. He's getting used to that, but the important thing is that his teammate does have the footy.
So Brendan Fuster for his third from directly in front. It's a goal. Well, the Eagles seem to have them covered now, Roscoe.
Well, it's an important one for him. Just gives him that extra bit of breathing space going to three-quarter time. And the third one for Fuster, as I mentioned, the target. Matera again, just spotting Simmons free. He's been good again today. He's been very consistent all year. 8-9 for Paul Simmons. And then the ability to kick the ball, set up to his West Perth teammate.
It's some comeback, of course. We mentioned coming off a knee reconstruction. One game in the West Star rules.
So little football.
He's really stepped up in company this afternoon. Cousins. Wooden missed it. Cousins goes again. Banfield. The confidence on the rise. Banfield inside the 50. And Fletcher comes up to take the mark on his chest. Morgan is down. I suppose when you talk about Brendan Fuster, the man with the ball is Morgan. Gingerly up. As Fletcher kicks towards the outer side, makes the performance even more admirable because Fletcher, one of the best defenders in the competition. Danny Morgan in a lot of trouble.
Yes, he doesn't look too good at all. As Wellman brings it in to Gary O'Donnell. Oh, straight up and an up and under kick that one, but Hurd is deceptively quick. He's getting the hoots of the crowd.
Believe that.
And only because he's a champion. In towards half forward. Here's a chance for the Bombers. Around the corner, a shot at goal by Blumfield. Oh, and hit the post. Oh. Nothing going for the Bombers at the moment as Denny Morgan is being helped off the ground. Bruce Reid, the club doctor's out there with him.
We'll see this again, but he's had 19 touches too.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, there might be more heard.
We made a comment early in the game that that wasn't happening, but it's coming back, isn't it, Pete?
Massidi on the ground. Luck for Essendon and Matthew Lloyd because that last kick at goal could have easily marked, or at least marked, I think, running back with a flight of it. Let it bounce, and it bounced against the post. Hurd spilt the mark. Pryor, the chip pass across the ground. Kemp got in front of Alessio. Hit the ground running. There's the siren for three-quarter time. And the West Coast Eagles will be delighted. Kevin Sheedy runs onto the ground. Putting the word to Michael Pryor. Gave him a bit of a G up there, but a pat as well. Kevin Sheedy right into the coaching aspect of things at three-quarter time without missing a beat. Morgan is off the ground. He made the point. I think we will hear more of that in the forthcoming week. A terrific turn by the West Coast Eagles. They were challenged more than once, but into the breeze they put their stamp on this game.
The 1997 AFL Premier...
Only figure, Jason Ball. Hurt his ankle earlier in the game, won't be back, we're told. Hopefully he's okay. Three-quarter time. Schuster and Matera, three apiece out of those 11. And for the Bombers, James Hurt has got three. Two in that quarter. And the margin is 26 points. We'll talk about the ultimate tag. Both captains go out. More of that in just a moment. Checking that final score in from the MCG. The Western Bulldogs winners there, 16-7 to 10-11. Both captains out to the umpires at three-quarter time. Almost predictable after what we saw. McKenna first. And O'Donnell is about to appear as well. Where's Garrett? There he is. Now, here's our case. At least Dennis has got a smile there. But obviously, both captains thinking it was all a bit rich. Adrian Barrich is down on the boundary.
Dennis, what an atmosphere down here. It's unbelievable. If this is not a finals-like atmosphere, I'm not here. It's just both groups very pumped up. The Eagles are saying, don't just let the breeze do it for you. We've got to kick some goals. Special attention paid to Fraser Geary. The Eagles know that James Hurd is the match winner. He is the key to the game. Fraser, you've got to hound him. You've got to stay with him. You've got to continually play on him. The Bombers, from their point of view, saying we must win. We cannot afford to lose another game. We just got to win.
OK, well, the Bombers looking down the barrel at three losses in succession. The old cliche, eh? In the huddle, don't let the breeze do it for us. I think we've all heard that one before. Start of the final term at Subi. Controversial third quarter. We'll hear more about quite a bit of what happened there, I think. Alessio, meantime, knocks it down. Across it comes to Denham. The kick floats towards the 50. Geerick fisting back. Bounces inside the centre square. Schofield with dash comes away. Kicks down towards half forward. Only one man on the road, though. That's Lucas. Wants his left side. He's very left-sided. Gets him into trouble on occasions. Gets away this time, though. Kicks towards half forward. Falling over was Blumfield. Dashing in was Hardwick. Well played. Fraser dragged off it. It affected the kick, obviously. Morrison, Lewis cruises by, just missed Young. Meantime, McKenna goes down towards half forward. Jakovic has it knocked away by Lucas. Lucas follows on from his own work. Looping hand pass releases Massidi. The Bombers now in quest of an early goal. Goes in short to Young. Oh, my goodness me.
Now, don't reverse this, umpire. If he reverses this, it'll be poor umpiring. Because
reverse it?
No, sometimes they do when...
Well, that was about two steps too late.
Yes, and here was the player he missed just earlier on in a shepherding effort. And Kieran Nichols is the umpire there, number 20. Young takes it.
Well, he's still down, Barry Young. And he's hurt, and they're calling. The doc Reed's a bit worried about it.
What's the umpire doing? Is he going to award 50 here? He's walking away with a group of players. Now he's coming back to see if Young can take his kick. Well, there's
stretch
no chance
coming
of that.
Yep.
Stretch has been called for.
So they've got to use that now.
And we saw Morgan come off after a clash earlier with the same player. The worst for wear. And here's Barry Young.
We're not taking... This 50 metres got to be further than where Dennis Richards standing, surely.
Yes.
Yes.
Now, we've got to say there was no report there, but it's a 50. That in itself is interesting.
And who are the crowd booing? Barry Young for getting flattened.
Just having a practice boo, I think. Yeah. He's a tough hombre too, Young, so for him to be coming off with any assistance indicates that it was a pretty good knock.
Peter Matera's back around the boundary line too, by the way. Dennis, he went down the race at three-quarter time.
Young bleeding slightly from the mouth there.
Am I incorrect in saying if the stretcher's out, you must come off on the stretcher?
That's my understanding. Where did the stretcher go? I didn't see it come out.
It's right behind him still. So,
it's right behind him.
So I would still think that even if he's okay in a few more minutes, he can't come back on for 20. Which may preclude him, depending how long the quarter goes, from coming back on at all.
Well, Renshaw's back on the ground. Pryor's got the ball. They've been given 50. Did anyone see a notebook there?
Yes, now umpire Nichols is writing something now, Dennis.
Okay.
Just tucking the book back in the sock, or the pen in the sock.
Well, I made the comment earlier in the game that Chris Lewis hasn't been involved in anything for a long time, and well, there's been a couple of incidents today.
But... Well, if you want to keep thinking that, don't read the papers this week, Pete. There's Pryor. He's 20 metres out. Going at a ninth goal for the Bombers here. And the former West Australian, I think, has got it. He has. Great start for the Bombers. Pryor gets his second.
Yes, he kicked a terrific goal in the first quarter, and of course is the recipient of that one because Young is unable to take the kick. And that's maybe the goal that gives Essendon the impetus to get themselves right back in this game, although 20 points in a margin, Pete's not that great a margin.
I know that's not much with 18 and a half minutes left. Admittedly, the Eagles are kicking with the breeze.
Well, on the basis of how they've been able to structure the game so far, but they've struggled to kick enough goals. So,
yeah. Well, you're right, too, Ross. Sometimes these incidents can fire aside. There's Griggich. Oh, well played by O'Donnell. Here's Lewis. Well, the crowd love him. Down towards half forward. The mark has been taken by Donnelly. And Donnelly would be 70 metres from goal. Jakovic is down there with Fletcher. He's kicking it to Jakovic. Out he comes. And that's Fuster, in fact, not Jakovic there.
Very similar, though, people, those with that knee bandage. They're such big fellows.
Well, they both had those knee reconstructions. And a good effort at the back. And the champ is coming back on.
Yeah, Trent Cummings will have to come back off.
Peter Matera. Barnard has locked in, and the crowd's roaring. Matera is back on the ground. And Jakovic having plenty to say out there. Matera would be close to best on the ground in the wrestler.
Done very, very well. Just to have a little extra strapping on that left knee just to support the area.
So forward pocket for the Eagles. Talking about Matera, that was Philip Matera trying to crash through. Massetti receives from Gary O'Donnell. This could be dangerous. Here's Josh Wooden bending it back. But the mark has been taken by Jay Massetti. He's been on and off the ground a few times today. The chip pass finds Chris Danaher, who unluckily wasn't awarded a goal in the third term. Should have been an advantage situation. Gehrig couldn't mark. Denham, Massetti trying to knock it on. Here's Josh Wooden again. On to Morrison. He can run all the way to 50 here. Chad Morrison bombs a goal, a long raking drop punt, a ripper.
Yeah, good use of the ball by the Eagles there, Pete, just to share it around in the congestion and then finally break free across the wing area and allows Morrison to use his pace. And he's really developed in the last few weeks as a player, as Chad Morrison. He's had a couple of mining jobs, and today just running a little free up. And here we see Wooden involved as well. And this. The youthful Glenn coming into the side. Down to pace and do. That's a great kick from 50.
Well, the margin, it's, well, they've gone out to 26 points now. So very difficult for Essendon. Alessio, Denham. It's a ball is locked in there and the umpire will come in and bounce it. And Lewis shoving Alessio out of the way now. Denham having plenty to say to the umpire, Kieran Nichols. Let's see what happens at this bounce. Essendon haven't been able to get a burst of two or three goals. Ross, have they? So, again, Alessio gets his hands to it. Denham charges in, socket off the ground. Jakovic after it. O'Donnell, well done to Barnard. Here's Joe Massetti. Good kick. Finds Hardwick. Hardwick in the centre of the ground.
Hardwick, very high one. Holds up in the breeze. Banfield, courageous attempt. Simmons written into the ground on his knees. Pryor digs it out wide. Morrison's got the run of it. Back to Banfield. Throws with his right foot down towards half court. Jakovic. Close to the boundary line. Still Jakovic. Jakovic and the youngster Lucas. Well played by Lucas. Worked him off the ball. Gets the hand pass to Denham. Barnard. There's a bounce. Storming up the ground. His second bounce. He was watching Fraser Gehrig earlier. Gives it away. O'Donnell dragged down towards midfield. And Hardwick.
At the Pryor. The Bombers go forward.
Matera. Oh, he is good. He is quick. And he got there first. And that was very good football by Peter Matera.
Peter Matera playing his 150th. Big game for both these clubs this afternoon. Here's Glenn Jankovic with his thoughts on the outcome.
I like to think that, you know, now that it is a great rivalry clash, and obviously it certainly has been off the field with a jacket waving and things like that, but, you know, once again, we hope that we're doing it this week.
So it's at half-forward for the Bombers. There's big Ryan O'Connor, Hardwick, Fraser, a quick kick. Hurd, can he take a mark? Punched away by Gehrig, but Hurd's like a cat. He's after it. Gets it back to Pryor. He's caught. Gets in a hand pass. No, he doesn't get in a hand pass. He's holding the ball after that good tackle. Kemp to Gehrig. Fraser Gehrig. Back to Kemp. Kemp will drive it low to centre wing, and the mark has been taken by Glenn Jankovic. Up he goes, the big fella. Hand pass. It was meant for Kemp. And the free kick should be the Donnelly here for holding the man. And it will be way out there at half forward.
Free kicks, 10 to West Coast, 5 to Essendon. It's twice as many as that have been missed.
Donnelly down towards the pocket. There's ball behind. Chance for Wooden, runs onto it. Deep in the pocket. Can he slot it from there? I think he can. Sharp angle goal.
Well, he's been a handy contributor when he's had a bit of a run, as Josh Wooden. 10-1 now. That's a clever goal. Could very well break the back of Essendon. Just the tackle on Pryor on the Essendon half forward line, receiving the ball from Hurd and unable to get a kick to it. The rebound from the Eagles results in a goal at the other end. That's what really hurts you. Clever stuff.
Yes, they've been too good today, the Eagles. Essendon. Now, the umpire's talking...
Blood rule, I think.
Blood rule, yes. There's a little nick on the knee, I would think. It'll have to come off. Is it Danaher? I think it is. Yes, there it is. So there's a report on Barry Young, Adrian Barrage.
Yeah, Pete, a bit of controversy over the situation with Barry Young. He didn't come off on the stretcher, and the stretcher was out there, and the Eagles are saying, well, he can't come back on for 20 minutes, and the interchange steward is unsure. So if he comes back on, it could raise its ugly head, that situation.
So Somerville coming on the ground, and Danaher to come off with that blood rule. But it looks a little bit lost at the moment for the Bombers. They just haven't been able to go forward and kick three or four quick goals. The Eagles have had the answers all day. Alessio and Grigich. Denham has worked hard in the middle. Lewis went without it. Hurd to Hardwick. Here's Matera waiting for it. Well, it was a little bit too casual that time. Fraser, Alessio, very mobile for such a big man. Gives it off to Massiti. He's trying to get onto his right foot. Oh, could have given it off to O'Connor. They need someone to take a mark. It's over the back. And Fletcher is now down forward. It'll be a throw-in in that forward pocket.
Did that a few times last season to good effect. Picked up some goals. They need them desperately here. Just under 14 minutes till full-time. Margin has blown out to 32 points. All hands on deck. Michael Malthouse. James Hurd bounces it down towards full forward. Lloyd, has he got the ball? He's playing it along in front. Fletcher with the snap. He's missed.
Well, Fletcher certainly moved forward. Scott Lucas has picked up Donnelly, who's taken over basically centre-half forward. Jankovic has come back to pick up Somerville. Hurd has pretty well gone onto the ball.
McIntosh bends it. To Gehrig, tantalisingly close to Alessio, short one to Matera, who's a left half back. They hang off him initially, so he runs it up towards the wing. Too much carry for O'Connor, but Lucas gets in behind, marks on his chest, wants to go from the wing, sends it back inside the 50. Lloyd's in front here and takes a strong mark, and that should be 50. McIntosh cannoning into Lloyd, and what's the umpire doing? He's setting the mark. Watch it again. That is a delayed reaction from the fullback. No question. He's got the mark. Okay, will I fall on him? Yeah. Still, here's Lloyd.
Yes, he was a player that they were considering to be very dangerous. He's had time on the bench, just the four kicks. This is just his third mark, so he's had very little influence.
17 goals starting the day. Career best of 7 against Adelaide, round 19 last season. 19-year-old, wearing number 18, kicks very truly. That's a magnificent effort. Fine goal.
Yes, and that's the sort of effort from Lloyd that they were concerned about coming into the game. Player who's matched him for most part of the day, and a difficult matchup it is for young Lloyd, a player who's bigger, stronger and quicker than he is. And it's a bit the same as Hurd, the Gehrig matchup, just a player that they're not quite used to having before, although Hurd's influence has been pretty good. We do judge players like him very harshly.
25 points the margin. Scott Lucas has been quite a good player. He's had a good battle at times with Jakovic. Or Cousins goes to ground. Essendon players after him. Joe Massetti getting plenty of kicks in this last term. And this is a mark. Alessio. Well, they're still
working.
Well, they are. They always do. The last few years, you can never write off Essendon. They keep battling hard.
See this again. Jakovic just unable to make up the ground that he gave. Alessio heading toward that footy.
Well, he's going to have a shot from just outside 50. You think it'll be the distance would be a doubt. He's pulled it slightly. He'll lob up in the square. The high flyers are there. And eventually it's forced over the line. He'll throw in right next to that behind post. Still just under 12 minutes left in this game. So plenty of time for the Bombers. If they can sneak one here, well, we might have a contest yet. O'Connor against Turnbull. Back it comes towards the boundary line and the players let it roll over.
Eleven and a half minutes to go, just over. Turnbull. O'Connor. Alessio may join them. No, Turnbull wins it down. Hurd snaps. Bad effort, slides it across the face. Lloyd back across the body, hits the post. Another one. Good effort. That could have made it interesting. As it is, they're not done with yet. Margin, 4 straight kicks. You get the feeling the Eagles have eased off slightly. McIntosh feeds it to Matera, who runs up towards centre half back. No margin for error, though, for the Bombers. Another goal could just about end it. Grigic, who's played pretty well, feeds it out very wide. Jakovic has been terrific. Masterstroke by Malthouse, putting him on the forward line. Now Simmons. Simmons from 45. Donnelly goes back. Loose ball behind. Matera's got 3. He's got space. He chips. Too much carry on it for Morrison. Coming in as Fuster spins out of trouble. He's agile for a big man. Gets it to Simmons. Simmons off a step from 35. Increases the lead to 25 points.
So Simmons has been a good player, 13-13 to 10-6. Sean Wellman is down there at fullback at the moment. He's going to be fiddling around too much with short stuff. No chances to be taken here. They need to get it down their forward line pretty quickly or stick to a contest. And well done by Banfield to get over there and force it over the line. So it looked like a capacity crowd here, and what's that, Dennis, that capacity? 38,
nearly
39.
Bit under.
And most of them barracking, although there were a fair few Essendon scarves I saw coming to the ground. There's Hurd. Up in the air to the halfback. The Bombers do have a very big following around the country. Massetti having a good final turn. It's forced over the line for another throw-in.
Interesting point you make there, Pete. I think they've probably got the biggest following of any team here in Western Australia. Outside of the Eagles and the Dockers, that is. Including my son. He's not there. Tossed in. Grigic. Big swipe at it. Kemp. Cuts infield. Centering kick. Morrison. Morrison right on the 50.
Given his last effort on the run.
Plenty of time, Chad Morrison, a young Victorian, Important kick. It's a towering kick. It's a wonderful kick. Yes, it's a game-breaking kick.
Yes, and so should everyone applaud. That's a magnificent kick. Just the confidence now that's coming into his game is great for him and the club. The maturing process is taking its natural course. Is he off the boot the way he dropped it down? Looks like it might have been a bit of a floater, but he actually got under it enough. Great kick.
Well, it's curtains for the Bombers now. They've been gallant. They've been trying to get themselves back in it, but they just haven't had the players up forward, which is unusual to say that about Essendon. To kick the goals. There's Hurd still working hard. Under Denham to half forward. Good mark. Michael Pryor. Now, they need someone running for him. They've got it. O'Connor, who might have been interfered with. And he's caught one around the head, and he's holding his head now. He thought he might have been poked in the eye then.
But just looking at Josh Wooden take the ball over the line, it's been great today that the bulk of the goals for the Eagles have come from their younger players. Fuster, Morris and Cousins, Phil Matera and Wooden.
Yes, they have had some good young players. There's Hurd. He's a good player. The CD to Hardwick. Now, there should be a mark here to Lloyd. Oh, I couldn't quite hang on to it.
A free kick for a push.
Push in the back. Yeah, there was a bit of a push there. The hands were definitely in his back.
That's where the umpires make it hard for themselves, Pete, because there was a push there, but when you don't play it early in the game or for the bulk of the game,
yep,
that incident or other pushes in the back, then you
exactly
create a problem.
Well, he was trying to punch, but he definitely got him in the back, and up high, up in the neck region, so it was definitely a free kick. But as you say, Roscoe, there's been a lot of others today in the back that haven't been paid.
Ben Doolan's probably down the other end of the ground shouting to the umpire. Yeah.
Well, here's Matthew Lloyd. Shot from directly in front. He's already kicked one. And it's a wobbly, but it's a goal. So this promising young forward, who has had a pretty quiet game by his standards, has now kicked two. And the Bombers still won't lie down.
No, they won't, Pete, but if they don't get up and win this game, which at the moment does look unlikely, their run next week, they've got Western Bulldogs and the MCG. It's a bigger part of the season. Pretty tough for them.
Matthew Lloyd getting his second goal from the Bombers' sixth free kick this afternoon. 14-13, 11-6, still the breeze is strong, the Eagles have it, so it's hard to make a case for the Bombers from here. Hurd's made a difference in the centre square.
Well, early we were thinking he was a bit quiet. He's had 16 kicks and 8 handballs.
Exactly.
Now,
and
how
three
good
goals.
How good a player is he and kicked 3 goals?
That's what I'm saying, but we tend to judge players of that pretty harshly.
Yes. They set their own standards, don't they?
Champion's yardstick. Up he goes. Takes the ball, hand passed, but almost intercepted by Wooden. Chance for Ola Renshaw to O'Donnell. And O'Donnell's away. A couple of bounces. Grigic chasing hard. Well done by the big man. Banfield got across. O'Donnell not happy with his forwards there. Remonstrating while the kick was still in midair. Jakovic took the mark. Back in defence at the present time. And the ball is driven around the outer side by McKenna. Grigic got across there because of that earnest chase to half forward and Donnelly. And Donnelly is about 50 metres out. He'll go close from here. Long. The breeze just tugs it right. And through it goes for a behind. And O'Donnell had a point because into the breeze, particularly where he was, exposed to the breeze, he could only hope to kick it about 40 metres or so. And that ball fell in short. As to be expected, and Jakovic was there. Hard when the players are tired to kick it 50 and 60 metres. Here's O'Donnell from the short one. To Massidi. Massidi still deep in his own defensive area.
Had a big last quarter, Joe Massidi. In fact, I thought he was off the ground.
Bit too
left
long.
Off the ground a little bit too long. He's vital to them, Joe Massidi.
As perhaps now in hindsight, Pete, so was O'Donnell in that first quarter. Spent most part of the first quarter on the bench.
That was strange, wasn't it?
Yeah.
So this is Denham. Gee, he's kept going hard at it. Sean Denham. He's got a big heart. He's had 12 kicks and 7 handballs. Here's Donnelly. Oh, no mark made, a bit stiff. Well, he didn't mark it. It could have been a free. Kicked away by Big Rhino.
Ryan O'Connor, and he is a big, big man. So he goes back to do the ruck work. I know some of us coming in now. And Hurd as well. And Hurd, oh, he is a great player. Look at that. Fantastic, James Hurd. Macedi down towards Fletcher. He's got the bounce. He gives it up. Gary O'Donnell races into goal, and he has missed. Gee, Hurd was good at that boundary throw-in before.
Yes. Just wonder whether that was a goal that might have been their last gasp.
Margin 25 points. Schofield getting loose. McIntosh ignores that. Goes to Gehrig. Gehrig is in the back pocket. A little indecisive. Hardwick. Wanting to go to him. Dennis Rich calling him back.
Yeah, just kick it. Don't you feel it saying that?
Getting plenty of advice. It's taking forever. Gehrig then kicks it directly to Fraser. Well, hardly worth waiting for. Fraser from the 50. Long down towards full forward. In from the side is Lloyd down there. Waiting behind Banfield. Had the judgment. Drew Banfield. Cantankerous game. Short one. McKenna feeds it off. Schofield, he's away from half back. Denham, good chase. Schofield out wide though. Jankovic prods it up towards half forward. Donnelly, better second half from him. Andrew Donnelly just forward of right centre wing. Side up 98 to 73 inside the last 6 minutes of the game. Kicks inside the 50. Wellman directs it down in front. It was well played. Ola Renshaw wheels around, chips towards left half back. Lucas has got it. 14-14, 11-7. Lucas high towards the wing, getting across there. Hardwick, and that's a good mark under pressure. Being held, wants to go, gets rid of Banfield. The umpire goes across and has a word. Umpire Vernon,
should be careful. Hardwick has come into this game back from suspension.
Volatile player to Pryor. Pryor to World's half forward Matera. He's been wonderful on his 150th. A real stamp of class back there and through the midfield. Gets it to McIntosh, and McIntosh is away. He's had a good afternoon as well. McIntosh down towards half forward. Philip Matera, the overhead mark. Not really his forte. He's been lively on the forward line. Goes long. Lewis going back with a flight of the ball. It runs loose. Houston off the deck. That's his fourth. What a return.
You're right though, Dennis. The setup by Peter Matera across halfback. He's had a marvellous game. Quite in contrast to the effort of the team the previous week for Blue McKenna, who also spent a fair bit of that game off the ground with a bit of concussion. So it's been a real turnaround for the whole team. And everyone's featured and done something to contribute. And great confidence for Brendan Fuser too to have a go at this ball off the deck with a crook. This fellow with a reconstruction. Go to a ball like this.
Well, the Eagles proving once again how difficult they are to beat here at Subi. He is hurt again. Quick kick to half forward. Crowd are chanting. There's Fraser, Barnard. Alessio was grabbed when he didn't have it. It'll be a free kick to Stephen Alessio. And the Bombers are able to go down and get a single goal, but they can't put three or four together, which is what they need. Here's Fletcher. Matera has been brilliant. Oh, look at that. Handballs to himself, races across the face of goal, and then pinpoints it past and finds Simmon. He is a class act.
Do they have the confidence to do that?
To go back.
The goal
yep.
face. Such a confined area, Pete. That was terrific, yep. wasn't
Fantastic
it?
To watch.
No margin for error there at all to the right. It looks so silly. Maybe kicking the score for the opposition if he miscues. He's got wonderful skills, we know that. Cousins took a long time. Barreled. Hurried kick there from O'Donnell. It was Lloyd who got Cousins. Matera again. Well, he's celebrating in style.
She'll have an ice pack big enough for Benny Cousins.
McIntosh to Gehrig, decides to take on Fletcher. Banfield, it's four against two in this corner. Turnbull, McIntosh, Good chase by Ola Renshaw, but he can't run him down. McIntosh up towards the wing. Philip Matera has been overshadowed by his brother, but has played very well. Morrison, long in the Lewis direction. Lewis does brilliantly, uses the body. Got rid of Blumfield and has marked only 25 metres out in a slight angle.
Just a difference that a bit of pace makes when players are getting tired. But just the Philip Matera pace, Morrison through the centre, makes all the difference.
Morrison's been good, Ross.
Yes, he has.
Margin 31 points. This to make it 37. Chris Lewis, goalless so far today. Started pretty well. And the kick is true.
Well, 235 career goals for Chris Lewis, and coming into this game was averaging 24 possessions. That's his 14th goal for the season, so on the whole, it's been a very, very constructive season. Perhaps just marred a little bit by a couple of incidents today. There we see that on replay.
Well, they're waving everything here at Subi. They're scarves, jumpers, you name it. The old, well, they've got the Bombers beaten, they know it. That's Morrison again. McKenna, Cummings, and hiding the ball, says the umpire, and Ricky Ola Renshaw. It's pretty sudden death, wasn't it?
That's the 11th free kick for the West Coast.
Oh, so Ricky Ola Renshaw to Harper. Oh, Lloyd flies through the air. Hang on to it. They're chanting the Eagle song, and at the end of the game I think we'll see a bit more of that one.
So the chant is up around the ground. What about Kevin Chitty and the prospect of losing this game this afternoon? Cousins towards the outer side. Somerville takes the mark. Somerville, centering kick. Ola Renshaw had to wait. Wellman throws it on the boot inside the 50. Off hands. Gehrig hits for the line. It's out of bounds.
I don't think Sheets wants to talk.
Kevin Sheedy missed his cue last time. Here he is this time.
I've got no doubt about that, but that's footy. And deservedly so.
That was it. Good thing we don't pay him by the word. Toss dead. Connor was there. Fuster tries to flick it back. McKenna dives in across the line in front of Matera. 110-73. We're down to just over a minute to go. Really, the crowd has had the practice run with the scarves. Amazing. They decided that was the clincher. Hurd slung, kicks. I think he may have kicked a goal. What terrific awareness.
Well, he is a great player, isn't he?
Hurts, hurt.
Let's hope it's not serious. He's all right.
Well, kick your fourth goal in these situations and have the close-checking tactics of Fraser Gehrig, now finish up in 27 possessions. He's played predominantly through the middle of this last quarter and had some of his kicks in the game across the middle or towards half-back. It's just an absolutely outstanding effort.
And I'm putting him in the boats. And I'm doing them, Roscoe, for Sports World, and he will be getting a vote.
I've been told.
Yeah. Well, as you well know. But, I mean, to come back after a fairly quite first
yes.
Team, McGarrig was all over it. He has been sensational under pressure, Hurd. Here's Danaher. Sean Denham. Wellman. Barnard. Now, let's see if the Bombers can finish with a goal here. Now, Barnard onto the left. Where's Lloyd? He might go for one of his flies. There he is in the centre of the back. Taken by Fraser. And was it touched? I don't think so. It's a goal. So, and Mark Fraser, in the dying stages, has kicked his first.
Listen, he's found touches hard to come by today, Mark Fraser. Paul Simmons suggests he might have touched that, but Barnard sets it up to try and give Hurd a chance, but Lloyd over the top as well. was spoiled by McIntosh. Well read by Fraser, but I found those sort of situations hard to come by today.
Nine seconds then, too little too late for the Bombers. Somerville has to wait, knocks it down. Wooden dive in. Cousins just missed. I think it was Barnard cruising past. Morrison. Umpire fell over. Ball just missed him. There's Lewis, chased by Blumfield. Ball at his feet. Some free arms in there. Snap at goal from Cummings, bounces against the behind post, out of bounds, it'll be thrown in.
Cousins has to be helped from the ground.
He might have got him, or was he a leg injury?
Leg, I think one of it is ankle again.
And Barnard's walking off with him. That's to the right, you can't quite see.
There's the final siren. And the West Coast Eagles are winners 110-85, 16-14 to 13-7. And it's a sea of blue and gold here at Subiaco Oval. Victory for the West Coast Eagles, but Cousins in trouble. He's laying down on the ground. 16-14, 13-7, back shortly. Kevin Sheedy walking off Subiaco Oval. A bit of a wave, you've got to say. Nothing too much to it. Not a happy camper, Kevin Sheedy.
The 1997 AFL Premiership season. Proudly brought to you by Foster's Light Ice. For extreme refreshment. Telstra, making life easier. Qantas, the Australian airline. And McDonald's.
Well, a busy day. The last bounce of the game. Barnard cruising past. Cousins was taken high, goes to the deck, and he was taken off the ground on a stretcher. So, plenty happening this afternoon. I'm sure we'll hear a lot more about this game in the coming week on a number of fronts down in the West Coast Eagles rooms then.
Brendan Fuster got four goals, was very good today. The margin for the West Coast Eagles, 25 points. Busy day at Subi. See you soon.
This has been a Seven Sports production.